Hello there, and welcome to the 2013 live stream special. In the first part, I'm going to be covering a request that was made quite recently on some older videos of mine by someone who went by the name of Liu Bei. And he basically requested me to, shock horror, cover Liu Bei's campaign. So I will. Now, an interesting thing about Dynasty Warriors 3 Extreme Legends, aside from the fact you can keep all the data from Dynasty Warriors 3 and put it into the game, so you can have all the weapons and stuff like that, you can also play the original campaign. You basically go to Musou mode, original. Please select original from the main menu. Ah, yes. The first thing you have to do is you have to press load the original game. So you press this. So, now, we're basically... Hello, Papa Smurf. Good of you to join us. So, now we can use the Dynasty Warriors 3 game data. So, we've basically now loaded the Dynasty Warriors 3 game, in essence. Which is interesting. Now you can play all the original content. I actually don't remember if you have to do that each time, or whether it's a one-off, but whatever. So, one thing that's happened because I've put in the Dynasty Warriors 3 Extreme Legend is that all the characters are now unlocked, so you can play as any character you want. But for today's purpose, we're going to be playing as Liu Bei, since it was requested by a user called Liu Bei. And he starts in the L7 Rebellion. No surprise there.
Brother, let's go.
It's finally time.
Yes.
The rats are gathering.
Don't be so hasty.
Hello, Stern J. Good to see you. It's been a long time since I've seen you around, Stern J. Alright then, so this is the first mission of Liu Bei. Now, I want to underline a couple of things before we get a whole much further. There's basically a very interesting caveat to playing as Liu Bei. For those who are familiar with Dynasty Warriors 3, you kind of know about this, but basically, in a normal Dynasty Warriors mission, you play 7 max. If you play as either Liu Bei, Cao Cao, or Sun Jian, you play 10 max. They are the longest campaigns in the whole of the Dynasty Warriors 3 universe. You play 10 max. And you pretty much cover every bit of ground, from the very beginning to the very end, somewhat. Which basically sort of goes against the sort of traditional sort of sayings, like for example, if you play as Sun Jian, you're supposed to die at the assault of Liu Biao, but you basically take over the role of Sun Sei / Sun Quan in subsequent missions afterwards. And in Liu Bei's case, it probably means the final mission is going to be the Luzang Plains, where he takes over the role of Zhuge Liang. I'd imagine. Anyway, let's check out the introduction to the L-Turban Rebellion and see what's up.
In the spring of the year 184, led by their leader Zhang Zhao, followers of the religious group known as the Way of Peace rose up in rebellion across the land, their actions fueled by discontent with the decadent and corrupt Han Dynasty. This uprising became known as the Yellow Turban Rebellion due to the yellow cross the followers wore around their heads. The power of the Yellow Turbans knew no boundaries, instantly spreading throughout the plains of central China. The beleaguered Han sent out a call for help across the land to organize a campaign against the Yellow Turbans. With hopes of a better future for the Chinese people, brave men and women answered this call of duty, and thus begins one of the most turbulent eras of Chinese history known as the Three Kingdoms.
Alright, so that's your backstory to the game. Hello there, Kaizo Fighting. So in this mission, He Jin is the commander, and he is surrounded by some generics we don't really care about, as well as Liu Bei, We are basically seen as the commander of a force known as Shu. Basically, in the Three Kingdoms lore, Virtual 904, and anyone else who isn't familiar with Dynasty Warriors, there are three major factions: Shu, Wu, and Wei. At this point in history, the factions don't actually exist. They're sort of building up their armies, they're sort of under the command of the Han, but they form later. And for the enemy, there's Sang Jiao, the leader of the Yellow Turbans, and recently someone who I finished doing a playthrough of on my channel. And he's surrounded by a bunch of other generics we also don't care about that much. So the conditions for battle, pretty simple. Don't let Heejin die. Shouldn't be too difficult, except for one bit, it happens in about 10 minutes, and kill Sang Jiao. Think he'd be able to defeat him since he's quite close, but it's not easy as that. Equipment-wise, Liu Bei uses a broad sword, which means unfortunately we only have the tier 1 weapon at the moment. But it's pretty powerful nevertheless. Item-wise, as you can see, the Dynasty Warriors 3 Extreme Legends items are now usable in Dynasty Warriors 3 Music Company. So we're going to be going for HP, attack, defense, Nixia Buzu charge, and I think some luck actually. Bodyguard wise, I think we'll use this opportunity to power up the Royal Guard actually, which could be interesting to see. Might surprise a few people when I do the next part of DL Chun's campaign and suddenly the bodyguards are much more powerful. So I'll stick them out with a spear, let them attack, see what happens. Alright, so let's get started, because there's 10 maps to go and this could take a while. This is probably the longest part of today's stream, just doing this.
Go! Ye children of the Yellow Turban!
Run straight to that wall,
break the siege of the Yellow Turban.
As you do.
The
rebel. Alright, so basically Dynasty Warriors 3 is a hack and slash game, somewhat, where you basically play as a character and kill lots of other dudes. And that's pretty much all I need to say about the gameplay, kind of. You can do combos and stuff, like you can press square 2 times and triangle. So let's check out Liu Bei's moveset. Triangle is a sort of spin attack, which goes a nice area actually, just sits. Yeah, that voice cracking need. The voice acting in this game is infamous for being, well, bad. Not gonna lie. It's also why this game is awesome. Because the voicing is bad. So let's check out his move 1. Whips him up into the air. This is his second move. Nice little stun there. Not much to say about that. Let's check out his third move. So, how do we... Ooh.
You flaming idiot! Take this!
One of the most famous lines in the game. You flaming idiots! So let's kill off this guy if we can. Real quick.
I defeated Rock.
Alright, so that takes... So let's check out his third move, see how it does. It's basically a simple sort of AoE clearance attacks. No, not at all. I mean, some people don't like the cheesy voice acting, but I personally think it's a great appeal, you know. It's very cheesy, and the best thing about it in this game is that, unlike in sort of Resident Evil 1, I guess, or other games where it's sort of unintentional, I think in part they kind of ran with the idea. At least for this game, anyway. Boulders incoming. Apparently there is Papa Smurf, but I don't have it. It must have been only on certain versions of the game or something. I'm pretty sure that there is an option in later games to switch to the Chinese, Japanese voice acting, but not in this game. At least not for me. It must be like a certain version, maybe the NSTC version or something like that. This part can actually be quite hard if you don't know what to do. Basically, just run up the left side, don't get squashed by boulders. You can get cheaped out a bit here sometimes if you kind of just stand in the wrong spot, but basically just run up the hill, ignore everybody, and trigger a cutscene, which should be happening now.
I tell you, magic is nothing to fear. Attack!
Yeah, in the last few you could sort of switch between English and I prefer the original. This is his Musou attack. Very, very powerful. Basically, Liu Bei, Sun Jian, and Cao Cao, they have excellent attacks. They're probably some of the best characters to use. They're just ridiculous. Especially, in my opinion, Sun Jian, who I've played a bit with in the past for my own amusement. They have really good all-around stats, really. But then they are the leaders of their respective factions, so I expect them to be fairly powerful. You basically unlock them normally by completing any two campaigns with their faction. So, players 2 Shu officers to the end, you unlock Liu Bei. Players 2 Wu officers, you unlock Sun Jian. Players 2 Wei officers, you unlock Cao Cao. And they all have pretty good attacks in general, they're very powerful. You can also use arrows in Dynasty Warriors, which can be useful sometimes if you want to snipe out someone from a distance. But generally, you won't be using it too much. There are exceptions, of course. You have to fight archers of your own. You have to snipe them out. But archers are kind of a subgenre of battling. You won't really be using it. You'll basically be fighting on foot for the most of the time. Although occasionally you do fight on a mount. But you don't really fight many other people on mounts. You just kind of fight on foot for the most part. And that's the beauty of it. It's a very, very simple game to get into. Even if you've never played any other Dynasty Warriors game, it doesn't really matter. You don't need to know much of the story.
How can such as you hope to stand against me?
Zhang Jiao is now teleporting to your position. As you remember, he was basically on the south of the map. He teleports to wherever you are because he's a jerk. You can see the Musou is ridiculously powerful. And Sang Fei stole my kill. You dick.
Don't fall behind.
So that means I don't get the experience points for defeating Shang... what, the officer that Sang Fei killed. Oh no, Emma Ward having problems with the stream. Damn it, Twitch. Yeah, unfortunately Twitch has been kind of getting worse lately. They're apparently experimenting with a new video player, and therefore there's delays, there's all kind of... 2 seconds, I'm being interrupted. Alright, sorry about that. Ugh. I'm being ungraciously interrupted there. Just lame. So, what was I saying anyway? Ah yes, and now for the most trickiest part of the mission, the Great Yellow Turban push on the main castle. This is where you have to kind of be quick, basically. This is where the mission gets a little trickier, because now basically they're all going to swarm into the castle. So we'll deal with these guys as quickly as we can. Do I want to fight Sun Jian now? Yeah, I'm in a good position.
Witness the miracles, the way of...
hello, Malon Pan. Good to see you. So this is the commander, Sang Jiao. As you can see, we're sort of overpowering him here. Oh god, he broke out his own Musou. Ugh! Just fun. And that takes care of Sang Jiao. Or not. And he's out of here. Right, we need to now quickly head to the south. Damn it. Oh god, what am I gonna do now? Okay. You don't happen to be Melon Pan, do you? By any chance? Alright, so basically the reason I've headed south is what happens now is that with the arrival of Sang Jiao in his main position, this is on normal difficulty. I usually play all the the campaigns on normal difficulty, because hard difficulty is designed for characters who have their third weapon and are really, because everything scales really, really highly. Stunning, I didn't realize that. Ah, well, good to see you, Melon Band. Not seen you for a while. So, that's the only reason I don't play on hard at this point. I mean, otherwise I would, but basically hard is sort of like everyone has more health. Everyone's a bit more powerful. Now, the interesting thing about the Musou of Liu Bei, and I've noticed with Sun Jian as well, and I assume Cao Cao has the same thing, is that the Musou is basically designed to be a sustained attack.
We must wait for reinforcements.
So I'm going to explain as people are talking in the game. Basically, the attacks are designed to be kind of like sustained, so they don't just knock people into the air. They sort of attack in the same spots, kind of deal. I mean, I'm getting knocked around on already because unlike other characters who kind of focus on like immobilizing people, as you can see here, he's not getting knocked over, except that he did there because he was already dying. Alright, we'll see you in a moment, Stern J. Alright, so now we need to... Okay, I have an idea. So basically, their attacks are designed to be sustained, right? They're not going to knock someone into the air, they're going to just hit them again and again, which is very useful, actually, if you want to combo them, or if you want to keep them in place. Watch your me, I need to take care of another officer. But the disadvantage to that is that if you do it against an officer, they do have a chance to counter you with their own Musou attacks. Musou, when I'm referring to Musou attacks, by the way, I refer to the super attacks, which is, you know, this. This is what I mean by Musou. That's what it's called in the game. It's called a Musou attack. Basically, a super attack. You can fill up the meter by pressing circle. And you can use it whenever you want after that. You also have a charging attack, which you use by pressing square when you run after a little bit. You can block. You can sort of knock. Well, I'll explain that in a minute. So that's basically all you need to know about Dynasty Warriors 3's combat system. It's very simple to get into. As it's a story, really. There's not really much complications in the story. I mean, when I first played this way back in 2002 when it first came out, the only reason I got this was because it was on an old official PlayStation Magazine 2 disc, and I loved the game. I played it, and I loved it. And I love it to this day. Just a great PS2 game, in my opinion. And the story is really easy to get into. You don't have to know anything about Chinese history, but by the time you finish Dynasty Warriors, you will know a bit about the Chinese history, at least in terms of the games, anyway. Yeah. So, I'm just going to say this now. It appears my streaming today has hit something of a slight snag. So I'm going to sort of break this off in about an hour or so. Take about an hour's break and then come back. Try and do as much stuff as possible. But I'm not going to stop right now. I'm basically going to have to take a break for about an hour to take care of some business, it seems. Apparently, I didn't take care of the business. So that takes care of the gate captain. Gate captains basically provide reinforcements for the enemy or for the friendlies. There's the guy who created the ice thing. I'm going to take care of him very quickly. Yeah, 12-hit combo. Little nice bonus. That should massively help Wu.
We must fight well.
Yeah, it's based on a series called Romance of the Three Kingdoms. I actually should pick it up myself because I'm kind of interested in it. Having played the game, it seems like it's a very interesting sort of story, really. You know, this is basically what the whole game's based on. It's based on the Romance of the Three Kingdoms, which is a very long-lasting Chinese... I think it's meant to be semi-fictional, semi-real sort of series, but it's very popular in any event. Take out one Y here real quick. If I can.
defeated Robert.
Look out, A1. Whoa, let's see if I can get a double. Yes! I got it! A double spam of I defeat an officer spam. Brilliant. Alright, we'll ignore that gate and over to the other side real quick to deal with he. That's what the cool side with that. Yep, I am indeed Gutsman, and good to see you as well, Mr. Gutsman. I've been doing this for quite a little bit, Gutsman. It's sort of side project stuff, you know. And I thought since Soul Silver is streaming it, oh god, Sunjan's nearly dead. He's probably gonna die. But he can die, I don't really care. We've kind of basically fictionalized history, yeah.
This doesn't look good.
I should probably pick up a copy of it sometime. How much does the Romance of the Three Kingdoms cost? Yeah, obviously there's a few liberties. I think it's kind of implied, Mao and Pan. I mean, in the game, sort of spoiling what's probably going to come ahead in a little bit. I mean, the Battle of Chi Bi in particular. A nice little combo here on the skate captain. It's implied that Zuge Liang uses some kind of wind magic to project the wind in a different direction. But I think what probably would happen, I'm going to take a stab in the dark here since I don't actually know. I'm going to assume that basically Zuge Liang just knew how the weather worked. So it's kind of like, I know the wind's going to blow to the northeast today. So this will be advantageous to saying a fire attack. As opposed to, I am the magic wizard of wind and I'm going to make the wind blow northeast. Something like that. Fortunately, there is a casualty, but that's not a problem. I'm not going to fight Sang Jiao just yet. I'm just going to get a few more stat points. Yeah, Zuge Yong was a strategist, a smart guy. We'll see him a bit later in this mission set. Very smart strategist. He had great wars with Sima Yi, which was the Wei strategist. Especially the Wuzhang Plains, which is a very late mission in the history of the game. As such, so virtual 907. Do you have any questions about the Dynasty Warriors game? Are you interested in purchasing? Oh no, I knocked him over the gate. Which means I cannot get his drop. What a shame. Oh well, doesn't really matter. I've got some pretty good items, which is the only reason why this. Just ignore that. HQ's fine. If you see that announcement normally, it basically means the commander's under attack, but you'll be fine. And the only reason this is as simple as I'm making it is because I've got good items at this point. And the first missions of the first missions of Dynasty Warriors are usually the easiest. So the more powerful items and stats you have, the quicker you deal with enemies. If I was playing this as a first time, though, it would be a little harder. I won't be able to kill enemies quite so quickly as I am now. But because I have, like, the plus 10 defense and attack and whatever, I get through them pretty quickly. And of course, it pays to know I know what I'm doing, so I know where to strike on the missions. Alright, so now we've dealt with all the gate captains and all the officers, Sang Jiao shall now fall to my blade. As you do. Ah, the fun times. The morale system, by the way, if you are wondering, that thing in the top right corner, basically dictates how well the AI does. If your morale is high, it's very likely that your officers won't be killed, and that they will charge attack. Again. I should be countering when he does that, to be honest, but nah, whatever. Not really that good at it. I basically think morale is higher in the enemy. Oh boy. No, why did I get up into that? I should have known a lot better than to get up into that attack. Really. Oh god. Hey! By the way, if Sang Jiao ever uses his Musou attack, don't get up during the middle of it. His fire attack is pretty devastating. It's best just to stay down and not get caught at all. Ah, he's getting distracted by Cao Ren. Oh, True Musou in a minute. True Musou is basically where they use the super attack, but on low health, it's much more powerful.
Oh, my body may die. My spirit will live forever.
And that was the L-Turban Rebellion. Oh, Liu Bei, that is a boring pose. Why can't you be interesting? Whatever. So, basically, a quick overview of the mission. We went to the east, took out a gate captain, defeated Zhang Bao. Zhang Jiao teleported, but we killed him. Then he appeared at the main camp. Then Zhang Man Sheng showed up. Defeat him quickly or else your castle will be swamped from too many angles. Then we took out Zhang Liang, Pei Wan Shao and Guan Hai in quick succession. Gate captain took out over there. Went over to the northeast, took out another gate captain, He Yi, and the gate captain over there. And then we just dealt with Zhang Jiao. And you'll notice that in the bottom left corner of the map was never used once. Or for that matter, the bottom right. It's like they just put gate captains there and then just never bothered to have any action in those areas. I mean, dead seriously, the bottom left and bottom right, they are ignored entirely. You'll never ever go there. Oh yeah, this game would have blown minds completely, Gutsmang. I mean, imagine it. A hack and slash where you fight dozens of enemies. It is pretty awesome. And after battle, you get some weapons. This gives us more arrows and Musou charge bonus, so we'll take that one over a blank weapon. And you also get items. Fortunately, they're pretty shitty because early on... Well, we're not shitty, but because I've played this quite a bit, I have good items, but stats. So only the later missions will give decent bonuses for me, unless it's a new item. And then at the end of it, you also get points based off KOs, worthy opponents, the time you took to beat the level, and bonuses for stuff like keeping your bodyguards alive and other stuff. There are other reasons for the... And combo is something that was added in Extreme Legends. You get points for doing good combos. And it goes towards... Well, character progression. You gain classes... Which basically means you're a little bit tougher, you don't get knocked by so many enemies. Oh good, they got more attack. Great. Basically, the higher class you are, the less likely you are to be knocked around by enemies later on. So like later on, you can take a hit from a sergeant, just glance at it and go, pfft. Whatever. It also allows you to ride more advanced horses and stuff like that. Bodyguard's got a growth point there, so ranking-wise... Didn't beat Zhang Jiao's run. Didn't get anyone KOs. What year did it come out? 2002. This and Extreme Legends came out. Extreme Legends, I think, came out the year after. And we actually beat Zhang Jiao's time this time. Good. It's basically counting the Extreme Legends times. These times do not include Dynasty Warriors 3 character playthroughs. It's only counting Extreme Legends stuff, so we'll just put a save here on the side. Alright, so let's see what the next mission is. Yeah, no surprises there. Battle of the Wild Gate is next.
I suggest my Lord Wan Shao.
Yes. All right, then. I accept the position of Grand Commander, and I swear to destroy the traitor, Don Zhao.
Our allies have begun their attack!
I shall accompany you.
Nope, I have not played Brutal Doom yet. It's on my to-do list for next year. Among many other things. Alright, so... Virtual 904 likes this game and thinks it's pretty good. You could pick this up for about £20 on Amazon, brand new. I strongly recommend it. It's a very good entry into the series as well, although... Well... The later games are a bit different, but if you want to play the classic games, Dynasty Warriors 3 is a really good start point, and I highly, highly recommend this game anyway, because it's really good. A lot of Dynasty Warriors fans who have played all the games also like this one as well. Anyway, introduction to what is arguably one of the more famous missions in the game.
The hard-fought struggle against the Yellow Turbans brought peace to the troubled land. However, this peace was short-lived, as the General Dong Zhuo emerged from the Yellow Turban campaign, hoping to seize power for himself. While pretending to serve in the name of the Child Emperor, Dong Zhuo enters the capital of Luoyang, seizing control of the government. With his newfound power and the mighty Lu Bu at his side, Dong Zhuo begins a reign of terror, shaking the imperial institution to its very core. Han loyalists, dissatisfied with Dong Zhuo's abuse of power, rally around Young Cao Cao's call to expunge the corrupt leader, raising an alliance to oppose him. With Wan Shao as their leader, an answer to the tyranny of Dong Zhuo is formed. In the year 191, the two forces meet in the lands east of Luoyang, with a strategically vital Fan Shui and Hu Lao gates as a backdrop. The battle for control of the land is once again about to begin.
Alright, so that's your introduction to Hu Lao Gate. Basically, after the Yellow Turbans caused chaos for the Han, Dong Zhuo causes chaos for the Han by taking over the government. Yeah, I've actually played a tiny bit of Brutal Doom, but I will do it at some point in its entirety, both games. The thing I don't like, Gutsman, is that it seems that there's a subset of people who play Doom who think that Brutal Doom is all that has to happen in Doom. Whereas in actual fact, there's plenty of good Doom mods out there that don't use Brutal Doom. It's like, you must play Brutal Doom and only that. No, you can play Back to Saturn X and lots of other stuff comes out that doesn't even require it. It's an add-on. Anyway, this is Hu Lao Gate. There's the commander, the Grand Commander, Wan Shao. I will be covering next year as one of the characters. And there's some generic ones. And there's us, once again leading our brothers, Shang Fei and Guan Yu. And they are brothers, they swore an oath in the garden. It's not really mentioned in this game, but it is mentioned in the next game. There's Sun Jian, there's Cao Cao, and there's Wan Shu. And for the enemy team, there's Dong Zhuo, the evil, tyrannical commander. And there's Liu Bu, the mighty, famous, possibly second famous character of the series, only perhaps second to Xiao Yun due to the fact that Xiao Yun gets on more game covers, Liu Bu. I might show you how powerful he is. And there's something that we don't care about. Alright, conditions. Wan Shao must not die. Dong Zhuo must perish. Pretty simple stuff, and if you know what you're doing, this is also pretty easy. There's only one really hectic moment, but I know how to counter that immediately. So, we're going to stick with the same items. Not going to go for speed, going to stick with luck. Actually, yeah, I'll stick with luck for now. So, let's get on with it. Nope, Gutsman knows what I mean. I'm actually going to save my MMO grindiness for Elder Scrolls Online myself, Gutsman. That's a deliberate choice.
Sun Jian, go straight ahead. Cao Cao, go to the top of the Fan Shui Gate. Wan Shu, you attack from the rear. Liu Bei, go around and keep an eye on the Hu Lao Gate.
Alright, I'm trying to get into a habit of not talking over in-game voices, because that's apparently a bad thing to do in Let's Plays, and live streams in general. I liked Coffee Break. I really did. Coffee Break was great. It was a good little short map set. It was just that one map that kind of sullied the whole experience. don't want to knock him down. The arena. Didn't want to get 8 horses, but whatever. Alright, so. If you ever play this map, the first thing you should always do, unless you play as Wu. And now we get Lubu's introduction, and the music will change. Yep, he's so famous, he gets the Lubu theme. He's the only character in the whole game that gets his own theme, which is pretty good, actually. Ooh, this is actually slightly different. It's like a remix version. This is not the original Dynasty Warriors 3 Lubu theme. This is the Extreme Legends version, which is slightly more interesting. I think. So basically, the first thing you want to do, regardless, is take out that gate captain I just took out, because it's very strategically important for an event that will happen a little later. If you take out that gate captain, this mission becomes easy. And then just basically proceed as normal with your shoe allies. In this case, see if I can get the combo on him. Yeah, I got plus 8, that's good. Basically, if you score an 8 hit or higher comp... Oh, ooh, my bodyguard's got a deadlock there. Too bad it won't...
Wanshu's army still has not moved.
What? Wanshu, you have deceived me.
And actually, that was really nicely timed, that one. I think... Oh, I'm gonna kill him with an arrow. Oh, I dodged.
I defeated Rob.
Oh, whatever. My bodyguards are getting a lot more aggressive now. That AI upgrade sure helped. People are gonna be... hopefully by the end of this mission, my bodyguards are gonna be, people are gonna be really, really surprised for DL Chan's fourth part, where it's like, hey, my bodyguards are now super tough. Here's why. East gate us forward, and now we must progress onwards really quickly, actually. So as you can see now, these guys are hitting me, but I'm not really paying attention to them. Probably because I have defense plus 2. So another smart thing you want to do here is, and generally a smart thing you want to do in Dynasty Warriors, is always eliminate gate captains quickly. If you eliminate the gate captains, they won't spawn any more backup, and eventually you can sort of whittle down the enemy's supply of soldiers. They will run out eventually. If so, what? There seems to be a lot of them, but the more you kill, they start to whittle down. They also do whittle down eventually if you just kill them quick enough. And Wanshu is dead. He wasn't even killed by Lubu. Guess Lubu didn't feel like killing him today. So Lubu's morale increases, here's Zhu Rong, we'll take him out as quickly as we can. Wow, I don't like the fact he has a vertical swipe for his aerial attack. Oh no, he blocked it. I didn't have enough to block it all though. There we go, Zhu Rong is out of the frame. Pretty simple. And again, this mission's also not that difficult if you have powered up stats again. And in general, it's not that hard, really. I mean, I did reckless stuff like this way back when I first played this. You can get away with it in the earlier levels, but just don't try it later on, basically. I mean, part of the reason I'm playing recklessly like this is because I have a lot of good items, but it's partly because you can get away with it if you sort of know, even when as a beginner character. So once Shu's gate captain has been closed. Such. Yeah, I agree with you there. It's like you want a refreshing change from Doom, you want to play some modern mechanics. It does seem a pretty fun game. And it seems like a lot of little... Use archers on horses. Always a good strategy. Now, this area can be a little annoying because there's a few archer towers, but just ignore them. You don't have to waste your time here.
Don't get too hasty. We must wait for reinforcements.
So, what are you all going to be doing on New Year's then, if I might ask? What's your plans for the New Year celebration?
You dare stand in my way, you pitiful worm.
Oh no, Lubu's here?
Don't pursue Lu Bu. Go to Hu Lao Gate and attack Dong Zhuo.
Oh god. Yeah. First rule of Hu Lao Gate, do not fight Wu Bu at all. Unless you have a real... He does a ton of damage. Wu Bu is a powerhouse as an AI. He can be defeated, but you have to use really cheap tactics. And he is a friggin' nightmare. He just follows you all day. I'm actually gonna have to get away from this, because Wu Bu can kill you very quickly. And he chases you like a demented dog. So I'm gonna have to change my strategy a little bit here. I can force him to come back. Oh, but I actually have to Musou break here. So I don't get caught by Wu Bu. Oh no. Oh good, he chose that attack. Phew, god. I am not kidding when I say that Wu Bu is ridiculously powerful. Ah, I've got Fan Shao on his own. Got a chance here. I mean, you could see how much damage Wu Bu did there. If he had hit his full combo, I might have actually died. So that's him out of the way. Ow. There's some annoying archers. Archers are going... You will learn to hate archers in Dynasty Warriors 3. They are a pain. They can actually kill you far more effectively than any officer can at times. Trust me. Kill archers as soon as possible. They're so annoying. In fact, there's a specific kind of defense that negates only their attacks called bow defense, which is one of the most useful items in the game later on. Staying home with the family. Yeah, I'm... Friends working went to one today. Get the Musou up here. It's the only way to get permanent HP and Musou upgrade is to find these items. Well, right, where's Huazong? Can open that gate, should be good. I'm not liking where Wu Bu went, though. He sort of started plowing off on his own against Cao Cao. Hopefully he'll just stay out the way, but he's actually in a really nasty spot. We may have to actually fight him. Let's see if I can eliminate Huazong in one go. Bam! One combo, he is toast. Ridiculous.
What's that?
So that's that. Eat lobster, enjoy some games. I'm not high enough class to even ride the brown horse. So good I am. Bam. Alright, so. That's the big gate that's fallen, allows Wu to come into play. And also means that Wan Shao will now be heading towards, near to where Wu Bu is, actually. Now, basically, Wu Bu is kind of the deciding factor of this entire mission. The whole mission sort of revolves around wherever Wu Bu goes. I mean, even a fully powered character struggles with Wu Bu, because he has the highest stats. But there are there is one very simple method of dealing with him. The only problem with Liu Bei is his Musou attack doesn't knock people in the air. So it's gonna be a lot harder. But we might try and take on Liu Bei, but I might have to make a save before I do that, because I figured out that Liu Bei is actually kind of easy to kill if you know how. But even if you know how, he can still kill you. Oh, Petronio experiment. Yeah, that's like really hard. I need to play that next year as well, Gutsman. I know that King Dime's also going to be running it for the ADGQ 2014. Which I'm going to donate to, just to see King Dime play it. Alright, so, Lubu's looking like he's going to stay there. Where's Wu Bu now? He's sort of staying near Cao Cao. So what does the chat think? Does the chat want to see me take on Wu Bu, or do you want me to just keep going with the story? I mean, I'm happy just to ignore Wu Bu and just get the mission over with. But I'm also happy to take him on if you want to see it. I can't imagine playing Bretonnia Experiments with Brutal Doom. It must be... Especially since Bretonnia, even though it's a very, very old Doom mod, it's like bastard enemy placement everywhere. I've not even really played it, and I can already tell you that the first level sets the tone straight away for how obnoxiously difficult it is.
We must fight well.
Okay, so a little trick here that really will help you for later on. There's a cutscene coming up.
If they only knew what they were in for.
What the fuck?
No release!
What the? That's not the original voice! That's not the original voice! It's supposed to say, ha ha ha, like lambs to the slaughter! I'll fire! They changed the voiceover to make him sound completely different! What the heck? That is weird. I was not expecting that. Anyway, the trick is there is that basically there's an ambush with archers. The trick is just walk away from it. The AI will take care of it for you, and you can go and you can not give a damn. Where's Wubu now? He's still near Cow Cow. Alright. Falcon says doesn't care for Dynasty Warriors. Gutsman says yes. Yeah, I'm actually going to be really pressured for time, Draukin, so we'll have to see if we can get onto the other stuff. Alright, good. Zhangwei Hao's troops out of the way. Gao Shun can die later, whatever. Gao Shun and Zhangwei Hao are basically the sub-officers of Liu Bei. Alright. Okay, so, regards Liu Bei. I've mentioned this before in my previous videos, if you've watched any of the very early stuff I did. But basically, there's kind of really only two ways to effectively fight Liu Bei. The first involves spamming him with arrows, but good luck getting the time to do that. The second and quicker strategy is true Musou spam, which is very effective. But the only problem is I don't have the best item for it. I really should have thought about that, whatever. Alright, so I'm actually going to pop a save here. I do that by quitting. The game, you get to save whenever you want. Okay, so I've made my save now. So if I die here, at least I don't have to replay the whole mission. I don't want to do that. Sod it. Let me do these archers first. Alright. So, I'm basically going to play very safe for now. But I'm going to wait for him to knock into me with his Musou attack. So the basic strategy of Wubu is... You kind of want to, as you can see, I'm hitting with my full Musou, and he...
Don't fall behind.
You basically can't really sting Liu Bei. I mean, you'll notice I'm hitting him there. He did not flinch. He does not flinch for anything at all. He has his defense is ridiculously high. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm kind of waiting for him to get me down a true Musou state. You can actually break my defense, I think. Yeah, he's not flinching. Look at him. He doesn't flinch. Oh god. He does not flinch at all. You can make him flinch if you have a super powered up character, but good luck with that. He's not flinching. Look, notice how he isn't getting hit at all. He just basically is like, whatever. I don't care. I'm gonna wreck your shit, son. Oh, here we go. Oh boy. You have to be very careful. Hopefully he's only using the basic combos. I think he's going to counter this into Musou. Nope. Oh, wow. I'm getting really good. I'm getting really lucky with Liu Bei here. Okay, here we go. True Musou spam time. I'm actually wanting to not kill my bodyguards if possible. Don't kill my bodyguards. I'm actually getting really lucky with Liu Bei here for once. I might be able to defeat... Oh, no. Musou spam. Deadbolt with Cao on. Oh god. As you can see, he's got very powerful stats. He's not... Doesn't flinch. You can't stun him. He's going to recover his health. Damn it. That's just unlucky. As I was about to say that I made this look easy, but it's not. As you can see. I'm basically just waiting for him to get me down a true Musou health so I can start the real plan and sort of just gain my wicks in whenever possible. I mean, I'll stun. I can't stun him. I'm actually gonna have to Musou here because he might. His combo was too long there. If he's not. I'm actually thinking of deliberately getting hit by that attack. Just to. We'll see. Okay. God, this is. Okay, good. True Musou activated. Here we go. Now, the plan basically is just do this a lot. It's the only thing that really knocks Wubu back. You'll notice he flinches to that. Then win the deadlock, rinse and repeat. That's all you do. Notice how he's actually taking damage from that. Quite a bit, actually. Oh, he blocked that. Don't let him. Oh, God. Notice how I actually hit him, and he's still healed. As you can see there, it's flinching. He's going to break out his Musou. Going to deadlock. Look at that. That's supposed to lift him into the air. It doesn't. So, waiting for some timing. I fucked up the timing. He's not going to get affected at all. Even on fire, he doesn't care. He still knocks you back. As you can see, even though you know the strategy for Fiend Wubu, it's not easy. Especially since I don't knock him into the air with my Musou attack. I think I've timed this right. I think. No. Someone else knocked him out of the way. Damn it. Oh well, he's run out of health. I think he's run out of health recovery anyway. Oh no, he did his AoE attack, which is super powerful and ridiculous. Oh god. This might kill him. It might also get his true Musou. Yeah, true Musou counter. Here we go. Goodbye, Wubu. Oh no, you lucky bugger. Oh god, no! Cow defeated him. Bullshit. Damn it. I didn't even get the kill acknowledgement. Damn you. Damn you all. Oh man, that should have been my kill. Son of a bitch. To all that effort, a freaking private steals the kill. That is just painful, man. That is painful. But I'm not going to restart the video just for that. Fuck it. You get a really awesome sort of... well, death scene if you kill him. Ish. But basically that's how you defeat Wubu. True Musou spam. But you do have to be careful. If you mess up one time... if you miss, if he doesn't... if you don't block in time, he can kill you. He'll just basically two-hit you because you're on low health and you die. So I recommend using that Way of Musou item where you can start with two Musou from the beginning. So there you go. Wubu's dead. The mission's easy now. Somewhat. And as you probably saw, might have noticed in the background, the ambush here happened with the two officers. But because the gate captain's been removed... they are only limited in number, so can be dealt with pretty comfortably. No problems. I'm good. What I'm really surprised is that Wubu didn't kill any of my bodyguards there, actually. I got really lucky. That is so good. Some help there. Right, let's go deal with these guys real quick. Always a good thing about... Liu Bei is that he can, at least he moves during his Musou attack, which is useful. Come on. So Gao sees out of the way. Might borrow his horse in a minute. As soon as his friend shows up, he do. I'll steal his horse instead. Screw it. Come on. Break him down. Did he die? 100. All right, let's go steal the horse and get this going. So here's the. I can't use it, can I? I have to use this crappy horse. This is the most basic horse in the game that you can use. It stops at everything, but it's a horse. All right, so now we can get on with the rest of the fights. thankfully. I guess I should mention at this point that what I'm going to do for New Year is I'm going to be going to a masquerade ball where I have to wear a mask. As Paul would say, why did you wear a mask? Man, Paul's a good streamer. Would you agree, Gutsman? Even though you're sort of a rebel alliance and you... would you agree that Paul was a good streamer in his time at Doltlifts? Ah. So now with that ambush out of the way, one Shao will be safe. There will be no further complications in this mission. And all that's left now is just to defeat Dong Zhuo and his bazillion men. And one girl. And now the chat's gone quiet. I guess everyone is busy. That's fine. Man, I hate this horse. I might consider getting Red Her in the next fight, so we can speed this up a bit. Good. One will continue on the basement. Nope, just working. Hello there, Swamp Goblin. How's it going? You know what? Ban the horse. This horse is useless. I can't be bothered. The AI haven't even dealt with the archers yet. This sucks. But I've at least killed a few of them. So we'll have to take care of them ourselves, I guess. Luckily, they have, at least they have targets to attack now. This is a lot harder if just you do it. Ooh, I should have hit him. I did hit him. Good. I'm glad to see that Swamp Goblin. I see. Also see that Draken hasn't had to do any moderating yet. That day will come, I'm sure. Oh, I didn't actually finish him off. There's a weird thing about the arrows in this game. Sometimes they don't actually kill people, like archers from a distance. The hit detection is very weird. It's almost like you have to be looking at the target just to acknowledge the hit.
Something is coming!
Forward! Bulao Gate lies before us!
Ah, siege weapons. But there is no actual siege weapons. Sorry to disappoint you.
When the gate opens, we will storm the castle.
Okay, you see these rams here? You have to imagine they're attacking the walls. Or more specifically, the gate. So yeah, you have to pretend they're basically attacking the gate. Even though they're not. I mean, in Dynasty Warriors 4, they would eventually introduce actual siege weapons that will actually had HP bars and actually did attack gates and shit. And you could destroy them, and you had to for some missions. But back in Dynasty Warriors 3, it was basically, just imagine the rams attack the gates. Use your imagination and stuff. So basically, you have to keep this assault captain alive. Now, this can be kind of annoying because there's a bazillion archers up there. So basically the plan is kill all the melee troops. And then once all the melee troops are gone, back away from the assault captain. Otherwise the archers will kill him. And then you win. So gate opens. Remember, the ram did all of that. The ram you did not see do anything. And then Liu shows up afterwards. He was the guy who called the archer attack earlier. Decided to show up in defense of Huao Gate. And he's a generic and he dies. See you later. Goodbye. Ah. Here's a familiar looking face.
Prepare to meet your destiny.
I'm currently playing as you in my Let's Play series. This is for not having your... This is for making me wait for your second tier weapon. Until frigging map 4. Although here she's just kind of cannon fodder and not too difficult to kill. See? She's dead. Bye.
Father, please forgive me.
And she's gone. Okay, so in Huao Gate itself, there's basically one thing you want to do as soon as possible. I'm going the wrong way. Whoops. I've actually managed to get myself turned around somehow. I mean, you want to kill these archers if you can, but they're not the biggest priority. I hate archers. Get stuffed. Stupid bloody archers. Go away. There we go. Alright, so now what I can say is properly. The first thing you want to do when you get inside Huao Gate as soon as you can, aside from dealing with these bloody archers who are flying through the walls, it seems, is you want to take care of these three gate captains. I'll just show them on the map. You can probably see them there. The three little pins. Hello there, Tiwi 7 inner back. He basically has three gate captains, and if you let him, these guys will spawn out enough reinforcements to keep you busy forever. So the quickest thing you want to do is you want to basically eliminate the gate captains. Leave the one in the middle for last. Otherwise, because there's three of them, they pull out a ton of reinforcements, and you can literally be here for a very, very long time. Especially if you're playing as a beginner character. So the smart strategy is plow straight in, take them out, and then slowly make your way to Dong Zhuo himself. Oh, I messed up the style finish. Whatever. Alright, so that takes care of that. And even then, it's not... The final one isn't too easy to do, but try and use arrows if you can. My arrows just tore through them. I try and use arrows if I can, so I don't provoke Dong Zhuo in the process. This one seems to be doing a lot of power-wise arrow. Oh, his stupid bodyguard blocked it. Come on, power-wise. Yes. You can sort of free-aim the arrows, but it's very difficult. Not recommended. Damn it. Moved. Be able to... There we go. Alright, now this will be easy. All the gates are down.
Yet another sacrifice to my glory.
Why don't you turn and run, you coward? Something he also does in Dynasty Warriors 4. He runs away instead of choosing to fight. And you have to chase him down. He's probably gonna break out his Musou here. Yeah, unfortunately the downside to Liu Bei's awesome Musou and any characters that have similar Musous is that if you do that to an officer, they usually break out their own Musou in response. The good side to this is if you win the deadlock, it doesn't really matter all that much. So again, he's going to break out his Musou. Unless you interrupt him at the right time, that is. Break by an archer there, going to power up my... Uh-oh. Oh, he caught me while I was charging my Musou. That was a stupid move. Good thing he's getting pelted by something. Try and hit him on the side here. Oh boy. Super Musou activated and good night.
No, my plan. It is all ruined now.
Yeah, he has a huge ass sword, I agree with you. And he's probably one of the more powerful characters in Dynasty Warriors 3 as well. And that was Huao Gate. A very fun mission. Indeed. I made it look easy, but it's not. At least not the first time you play it anyway. If you don't know all that stuff that happens before, you can have some fun. So once you got eliminated, Zurong fell quickly. We had a little encounter with Liu Bu, but luckily Fan Shu was destroyed. Wazurong fell pretty soon afterwards. And after eliminating that gate captain to the south, we made the reckless decision to fight Liu Bu head on. We scrapped for a good 5 minutes to defeat him. And even then he was killed by a bloody peasant officer or something. Then Liu Ju and Gale Xi showed up. They died. Fast forward a bit. Took out the gate captains, and Dong Zhuo fell in under 27 minutes. Simple stuff. Let's see if we get... No. No. I only got those items. Hmm. think. Ooh, a speed for the bodyguards. Very nice. It's always good. Alright, so another 6,000 points. Let's see how that translates to character development. Mainly the bodyguards I'm looking at here. Class 11. Come on, bodyguards. Get more attack. Yes! They got a growth point. Good. So that gives them... So they're gonna become very powerful. And I think I might give them some life as well. Although they seem to be doing fine. They took a Woo Boo fight pretty well, considering. Class 9. Alright. Could go for the rankings. Ooh, highest points. Nice. Not even on the KOs. We wagged behind Woo Boo, but then Andy El Chan's playthrough, but they played on the other side and a completely different mission to what we did. So not too shabby overall. Right then. I don't actually remember what's next, actually. Oh. And it's this one. Oh boy.
Will I see my land? When we finally cross over this hill? My people, what is it that I can do for you?
Lord Kaukau is approaching. He shall be here shortly.
Quiet! I will deal with Kaukau myself! Let me through!
So that's Shang Fei being a reckless person. Threatening to deal with Kaukau by himself. Huh. I actually thought there'd be another mission in this, but I guess it plays out a little differently. What's the two Hangang's third weapon? I don't actually remember, to be honest with you. I don't actually remember at all TW7 Inabar. Because I've played with Ganning, but on my other file, on my test playthrough memory card. Anyway, an introduction to Shangban it is.
Together, the Allied forces emerged victorious over Dong Zhuo. However, the Han Dynasty had already lost all of its power. One by one, each of the Allied leaders heads home, secretly plotting to realize their own dreams of power and ambition. In the year 208, with his forces concentrated in Huabei, Kaukau leads his troops south in an attempt to invade the Jing province. Standing in his way is Liu Bei, who was charged with the protection of Fan Castle. Faced against impossible odds, Liu Bei gathers his troops and people and attempts to flee. With Kaukau's army closing in, Liu Bei has no choice but to turn and fight, giving his people a chance to gain some ground on their pursuers.
Alright, so, Shangban. One of the very few missions in the game that kind of deviates from the whole kill enemy officer to win, defend enemy officer to lose conditions. So there's us. We're in a very good starting position. Nurse Xiaoyun, the poster boy of the franchise. Nurse Shang Fei. And here's the intelligent Zuge Liang, Shu strategist. Nurse... These are called the peasants, because basically these generic officers represent a group of peasants. And there's five groups of them. And for Kaukau. Alright, well, Happy New Year to you, TW7 Inabar. And just to let you know, I will be putting this up on my YouTube channel afterwards. All the highlights of each part, so that people who miss out can catch it later. Since I now have the technology to convert LV files to MP4s, and hence I can move on to YouTube. But yeah, Happy New Year to yourself. Anyway, for Kaukau, Zahundun, Zhangweiao, Zahuan. Hold on a second. God damn it. Alright, so as I was saying, Zahundun and Zahuan are brothers. Just so you know. And there's Shang-Yi, he's an interesting card to say the least. And there's Zhu Huang. And there's my favorite character in the whole franchise, Zhu Xu. He is awesome. You might get to see why in a minute. Unfortunately, slightly against my planning for today, I'm actually going to have to stop here for about an hour. So basically what I'm going to do, I'm just going to mute this for a sec. There, that's better, so the music doesn't interrupt me too much. I was actually going to plan on doing this for the next few hours, but I'm going to have to stop for about an hour and make some preparations for the new year. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to start the stream here, but I'm going to come back in about an hour. So what time is it now? It's 20 to 3. So if you come back here in about an hour's time, I will continue the stream. So I'm really sorry about this. I don't want to have to do this, but I've got a few things to prepare. So I'm going to have to stop the stream here, but I will be back in about an hour. So this is welcome back to part 2 of the New Year's live stream. We're carrying on with Liu Bei's campaign here in the third map, which is the Battle of Shangbon, where we are facing Cao Cao's forces. Okay. I'm starting to suspect that because I'm playing Extreme Legends, there's been a couple of changes here, because this is not the original victory-defeat conditions that I remember. Although maybe they just forgot to include it on the defeat conditions. Weird. Okay, good. Papa Smurf will be back, and hopefully everyone else. I've mentioned it on Twitter and whatnot. So, in the original Dynasty Warriors 3 mission, the conditions are defeat Cao Cao or Liu Bei escapes. And it seems in this, and defeat is achieved by either Liu Bei dying or the peasants. Actually, no, the peasants can die, I don't think they matter, but Liu Bei has to escape, basically. But it seems like you only have to defeat Cao Cao here, but unless, of course, this changes because you're playing as Liu Bei, which is entirely possible. So it's either changed because you're playing as the commander, or this is an Extreme Legends change. But originally, the peasant, you could escape this mission and not have to fight Cao Cao. Anyway, we didn't get a new weapon last time, sticking with the bodyguard. Let's see. Gotcha. I think I'll keep going with the attack once more, and then I'll give him some life, I think, for next time. Alright, so this time I'm thinking, are we going to need to rush anywhere? Yeah, I'm going to change it up a bit now. I'm going to basically equip the fastest horse in the game, the Red Hare Saddle. Or, no, actually no, I'm going to equip this one instead, sod it. The Hex Mark is basically Liu Bei's horse anyway, so let's equip it for a bit of speed and mobility at the Battle of Shangbon. It kind of sucks I have to break this into two parts, but whatever.
Don't plan on running from this battle.
No, we are running from this battle.
Protect the people on the way to Han Shui.
I shall give my life in defense of Lord Liu Bei.
Leave my lord's unit to me. Not even a dog will pass.
So one of the smart things to do here, it looks like a Smarties cookie. Yeah, it basically gives you increased luck, as does this horse, in fact. The horse basically gives you increased luck. And it is also Liu Bei's trademark horse, the Hex Mark. Man, now the AI is starting to damage me a bit because I'm a bit, well, beginner's character syndrome, basically, you know. So a smart thing to do on this map is basically to clear out the gate captains as early as possible. And then that way, because of the real event that happens, and oh boy, here we go.
I eat guys like you for breakfast.
I love that line, it's so awesome. My favorite character in the whole of Dynasty Warriors, Zhu Xu, he is awesome. Please land inside the gate. Yes. I love Zhu Xu. I didn't used to, but when I played his character, he's actually pretty wacky. He's basically this huge giant of a man who is, broke out his Musou again. He has a very powerful, ridiculous attack. I just love him. He's just incredibly goofy. He has some goofy lines. His attacks actually knock you back for miles if you let him. I'm not going to show it this time, of course, because
That's it. I win.
And his voice is goofy in this version. Of course, if you want to see more of Zushu, I did one of the original Dynasty Warriors 3's Let's Plays with his character, so there's the place to go. Alright, so now that we've dealt with this little problem, we can now go and kind of influence things at the back. We don't want to push forward yet, like, forward in this case is the southwest of the map. But eliminating that, I don't think there's any other options around here, which is good. We'll basically make the main event of this map a little easier to deal with. Somewhat. So now we're going to head to the north and take out the two gate captains that are completely unguarded. For now, anyway. And if we eliminate those, then basically Wei will be whittled down very quickly. And that's kind of what you're sort of doing in all the Dynasty Warriors games, really. At least the ones that had gate captains as a reinforcer thing. If you eliminate the gate captains, then the reinforcements will dwindle and you'll eventually win. I mean, they sort of changed it up in later games, like in Dynasty Warriors 5, gate captains can be a kind of more of a capturable base rather than something that...
You wish to fight me? How amusing.
I always say that bloody line. This is Zahun Doom, my first Let's Play character I ever did for the channel. I wish he'd say something different from time to time when I come across him. Why, they sort of made it more of a capturable base type deal. I think I've missed the chance to combo for 8 here. Yeah, fucking guard gun in the way. Whatever. I'm not really that bothered. But yeah, they made it more of a capturable property instead of like something you just kill and it doesn't come back. So that made it a little trickier. Like, gate captains could be captured, recaptured, so which kind of made a bit more sense, really. I mean, if you're going to have them in the game and have them have some meaning, you know, and keep them a constant sort of source of income, potential, I mean, it makes sense that it should be recapturable at some point. Because if you think about it, essentially, gate captain is like a reinforcement spawning unit, you know, like the things in Gauntlet or whatever. And honestly, if you just do that in most of the maps in this game, things become pretty easy. Of course, the kicker is you're not always going to be able to find them.
You shall not go another step
without bumbling into a bazillion guys. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is we'll just fight Zhang Liao and Zhang Jun for a little bit. Again, it's going to break out the Musou. They always break out the Musou if you have this kind of attack, which is great, which means you can follow up immediately. It's only to win the deadlock, of course. There we go, broke him.
You're even stronger than they say.
You're probably wondering, you might be wondering as you see that why he wandered back instead of trying to fight me, and it's because under certain circumstances, the AI kind of has a limit. Oh, he got me up first. Oh, he got me again. I'm going to go sort of move just to fucking take Zanjun off his course. Again, I should have attacked. Big mistake there. I never attack when they triangle. Basically, they sort of have like a, you know, like how the AI in Dark Souls or whatever, they kind of have a limit to where they're supposed to be. If you sort of push them within the limit, they sort of try to head back to the original point, which is they don't. Sorry, don't do that. Basically, they have a limit. So Cao Cao's main force has arrived, which means it's time to leave.
How can I face Cao Cao?
He's about 5 feet from you. I'm sure he'll be happy to see you.
I defeated an officer.
All right, so now we've taken out Zahun Dun and... Oh, God. This is an absolutely terrible spawn spot, by the way. Oh, my fucking God. This is the absolute worst time for him to spawn in. Literally, as I'm trying to break off from fighting him straight away. Yeah, so leg it out of there. I mean, I could just kill Cao Cao now and end the mission, but I kind of want to power up a bit for the later missions to come. So it's also a good idea not to just end the mission straight away. But basically, if you can force the AI back into it too far from where they originally are or to an area they normally don't bother, they sort of just focus on retreating back. They don't guard, and then you can just kill them. So a cute little sort of exploit there, but it doesn't happen too often, but it happens. And explains why the AI doesn't block you when you,
Give me strength! In the name of brotherhood!
Okay, that's kind of weird right there. That's supposed to be Shang Fei doing that normally. But I guess it's Liu Bei this time. I think, mind you, any character can do that as long as they appear after the mission is over. After the main spawn comes in, I guess. So one of the cool things about this game, I guess that gives it a little bit of replay value, is that different characters will say different things in the cutscenes if you play as them differently. Which in some cases can lead to an absolutely goofy outcome. Like, you can literally have Guan Yu fight himself in one of the missions where the main priority is to fight Guan Yu, etc.
We must fight well.
Ah, fun stuff. I hope that some of the people who came along earlier do return. It just kind of sucked I had to break... Oh, 2 seconds. God, I speak about being interrupted, and I get interrupted instantly. I wonder if that works with other things. Oh yes, and you can move your charge on a horse. If you want to do that. But yeah, it kind of sucks that I've had to break this down to 2 parts, really, because it's kind of broken my momentum. But, whatever. I bet most people will probably be watching this on YouTube anyway with Beyond Demand. Which is fine by me. This is all an experiment anyway. No, it's 2 experiments, really.
You think you can defeat our army? I am Liu Bei!
Oh boy, he says that convincingly. I am Liu Bei! Please be scared of me. And that's basically 2 events now that have caused morale changes. You know, or, well, I mistimed that. That was horrible. So again, you can see he didn't block there because he was running back to position. So again, he was able to be countered very easily. That little sub-officer or whatever. And yeah, just to keep in mind, this is the 3rd mission of Liu Bei's campaign, but it's... We're not even at the halfway mark yet.
I will strike him down.
Okay, Zahu won, whatever. You may try. You can also capitalize on the inability to focus on you if they get distracted by a bodyguard. The AI can sometimes kind of switch, kind of like an archvile in Doom, you know. They get struck by somebody, they sort of focus on them instead. I'm just going to buzz when we bust out my music here. Got lucky. Caught him. Weapon. Good.
Got a little carried away.
I mean, keep in mind this is the 3rd mission for Liu Bei, but there's 7 more to go. So we're not even at the halfway mark yet. So this game is kind of still scaling the enemies at a sort of easy level at this point. But it'll start getting a little bit noticeable how tricky everyone is to defeat a little bit. Probably the next map or so. So again, we're taking a bit of a risk here, but because of my high stats, this will be not really that much of a risk, really. This is also the last gate captain of the map, so if we pull this off, get my combo here, so I get the +2 defense. And there we go. Always useful. This elixir charge is really making this a hell of a lot more easier. I'm very grateful for whoever suggested it. Nice little archers, they fired the first salvo. And archers will try and retreat, as you've seen. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. I didn't hit a single bloody archer with my Musou, except the dice at the end. Wow. That was like the deftest sidesteppingest archers ever. This is the last one. It's a bit into the pack. Nice try. Get lost. Alright, so now we're going to look out for Shang-Chi. So at this point, basically, I'm just whittling down all the king's horses and all the king's men. and not even Cao Cao can put them back together again, so they're kind of further ahead. So, time for some suicidal charges-ish. Perhaps. Or we could make a stand around here and just wait for them to come down, because that's where they'll be heading pretty much. This point. But yeah, this is kind of a double experiment for me. First of all, to see how many people will come when I announce an Insta stream on my YouTube channel. And second of all, to see if people like the idea of seeing highlighted streams. Highlights from streams on my YouTube channel after they've happened. Alright, so since nothing else is really happening, I'm just going to keep killing officers. This mission is probably a lot more fun, to be fair, if you don't play as Liu Bei.
Pitiful fool. You will die.
Because then it seems the peasants become much more important. Now, Shang Yi's kind of an interesting character in Dynasty Warriors. Oh, good. You have to be very careful with Shang Yi's Musou attack, because his Musou kind of goes all over the place when it happens. He kind of slides around like some kind of dancer.
That was an impressive battle. Until next time.
His Musou attack is very kind of unique-ish. Instead of sort of being like a static sort of slash everywhere around you sort of deal, Shang Yi kind of floats around the map with his Musou. He kind of like glides, and you can combo with his Musou quite devastatingly, but not easy. I'm going to kill these archers first, because they're going to do the most damage. I'm not going to Musou this time, because it didn't work too well last time. And now that my bodyguards are actually causing a bit of threat, and they're able to stick up for themselves at this point, I can actually start plowing into battles a bit more recklessly than I even did before. Just because I have these bodyguards at my side. Oh god, now they get beaten. So that's him out the way. Unfortunately, knocked off a horse by guards who their master is long since dead. But it doesn't really matter. I mean, you can kill off a guy and his men will be morale-less, but they'll still be around the battlefield. Just there to annoy you. Only the actual guards that stand alongside the officer disappear when he is defeated. Anyone else is free game. Pretty much. Zhu Huang, of course, is still alive and will be coming up shortly. You know, by the time I get to this final cutscene of this part, I'm probably going to have cleared everyone out, so it will probably be mostly pointless. Right. Now let's go find Zhu Huang. And the second thing that's interesting about Shang Yi is that he is,
show me what you've got.
Is that I'm not exactly sure if this is actually accurate to his character in the war or not, but he's implied that he's That's how you break the Musou. You can also break their Musou if you get good timing as well. It's implied that Shang Yi is, I'll tell you in a minute, I'm just gonna this over.
I have finally met my match.
Turn me up. It's implied that Shang Yi is actually gay, in a nutshell. So now there's no purpose to being over here, we'll just plow on through these troops and go back to Cao Cao and end this map. But yeah, it's implied that Shang Yi is kind of gay. Like, actually homosexual, not as an insult or anything. I mean, he has a lot of... I mean, it's not really sort of meant... it's sort of subtly implied in this game. There's a couple of cutscenes where he sort of talks in a very sort of flamboyant way. Incidentally, his character reminds me a lot of Vega from Street Fighter. You know, just without a mask. But it's implied in later games that he's kind of gay. Flamboyantly gay sort of character. But again, I'm not sure if he actually is gay in the realm of the Three Kingdoms War or not. Something I'll have to check out sometime. Right. So Cao Cao is basically fighting Zhige Liang and Co. We'll go find him. As quickly as we can. Has anyone come back to the chat yet, Draukun? Or is everyone still not here? Oh, well, let's pop a smurf alive, I should say. More like. Yujin. We'll take him out and Coward Salven. Ah, Salven, you will be in Dynasty Warriors 4, but Yujin has to wait a couple of years.
I shall destroy all who get in my way.
Here's Cao Cao. Try to defeat him last. I'd rather take his suboxes out first if I can, but I'm more than happy to just kill Cao Cao right now. Get off your horse, Yujin. Wow, you can see my bodyguard again breaking out the Musou attack.
I
was kind of hoping to reach the other guy, but I lack the range at the moment. Stun him. Try and get some Musou charge. Oh, he got knocked into the air. Damn it.
I defeated Rot.
Well, whatever. Right. All that's left now is Cao Cao, pretty much. He's going to break out his Musou again. Whatever. No, he's not. No charge. What else? Decided not to use it. Also, another thing about Cao Cao and Liu Bei and Sun Jian and all that is that they do have... Oh, God, that's his Musou. Very similar... You'll notice it's very kind of similar to Liu Bei's and Sun Jian's. They're not quite clones, though. They're just very, very similar. Please do time. Nope. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Don't true Musou. You can actually hear his true Musou activate. That's a distinct sound. They have to be careful of. He broke it out, and very luckily I Musou'd. If he'd hit then, it would have stung. Now he dies. Please die! This is getting very tasty. And that's that.
I cannot die yet.
Alright, Cao Cao defeated. The first great battle of the leaders ends in victory for Liu Bei. But yeah, all the swords and all the weapons of the three leaders have great range. Not at the moment, but when they get their third tier weapon, you'll notice it quite a bit. So we defeated Zhu Xu, went up north, defeated Zha Hundun and Zhang Liao. Cao Cao showed up at a very bad time. We just about got out. And were able to basically plow for the rest of the map. Zha Huan fell, took out the last gate captain, took out Changyi, Zhu Wang. And then Cao Cao fell, 16 and a half minutes later. Pretty quick, but again, I sort of know where to go. So this mission can take a while when you first play it. I'll stick with that one. No third, second tier weapon, which is a bit disappointing, to be honest. No new items either. Man. Oh well. Oh wow, 7k score. We're getting some good scores though, which means half of that will go to the bodyguards. It's all that really matters to me from this. I know I can get 6 bodyguards by the end of this playthrough. Still no progression. Come on, hit 42. Bei gets up to first once general. Ah, just shy of development. Damn it. That's fine, Papa Smurf. You don't have to chat. As long as, you know, if you're interested, you're in. I'm just a little concerned that because I broke off the stream into two parts, that some people who are interested perhaps have drifted away. Which is fine if they want to drift away, but I hope it's not just because I broke it off. So, points ranking wise, outdid Zhang Jiao. Nice. Zhang Jiao playthrough was conquered. Not on the KO front, though. Ooh, not quite as fast as Liu Bu. But then I was really, really quick with Liu Bu. Alright. So that's mission 3 out of the way. Now, I think coming up next is a mission that's not been seen before on anything. I think. Or not. Never mind. We've seen this before.
Cao Cao's army, though massive, is but rabble. There is no need to fear. I shall depart. I leave the rest to you. We shall conjure a southern wind.
Okay, now tell me I'm not the only one who saw that bit with Shoyu in bed and Tsugi Wang and thought this is perhaps the beginning of some kind of gay porno. Or is that just me? It just feels kind of weird. We shall conjure a southern wind. And the imagination does the rest. Alright, so here we are at the Battle of Chibi. This is from the Shu perspective, which is kind of weird. To my knowledge, in Dynasty Warriors 3, this is one of only two maps where there's three perspectives. In this case, you have Shu, Wu, and Wei, and the other one being the Nanmon with Shu, Wu, and the Nanmon. Anyway, introduction time.
Liu Bei, having survived Cao Cao's attack at Changban, makes a valiant stand on the Changban Bridge, allowing him to get away. Having successfully escaped, Liu Bei and his men head east towards Jiako. Liu Bei's forces successfully escape to Jiako to find Lu Su of the Wu army waiting for them. This meeting brings an anti-Cao force one step closer to reality. With the fate of both countries lying in the balance, Zhu Geliang heads to Wu with a message. In 208, Sun Quan finds himself wavering between battle and surrender, until Zhu Geliang persuades him to join forces in the fight against Cao Cao. With both countries joined together, the strategists Zhou Yu and Zhu Geliang prepare a plan to attack the giant Wei fleet.
Okay, so this point Wei's pretty expansive since they've taken over Wan Chao's territory and are pretty much the largest force in China right now. And Wu and Shu are feeling the brunt of it, so have allied together to prevent Cao Cao from dominating. This alliance would go on to cause problems later, as you can imagine. So, for the allied forces, there's Sun Quan. We are no longer the chief commander, but now are under the tutelage of the Wu commander. There's the Wu strategist Shoyu. That's the most annoying voice in this level. Hopefully you'll get to hear some samples of it. There's Sheng Pu, there's Gan Ning, Tai Shi Chi, Han Dong, Zhou Tai, and... Now this is something you don't see every day. We are a sub-officer of a generic character, Maizu. And by generic characters I mean basically anyone who's not a playable officer. And generics basically have sort of like four or five templates. Sword generic, staff, spear generic, fan generic, and I think that's it actually. So we're a sub-officer of the only Shu person here at the moment. And there's Cao Cao, he is the enemy leader again. Zhang Wan, Zhu Huang, Zhang Liao, Zhe Shu, and a bunch of others we don't care about. Because they're generics, and some of them would wait to go on to get their own characters, and some still sit in the sidelines. So, victory, defeat Cao Cao, prevents Sun Quan from dying. No new weapons, and I don't feel like changing any equipment, so let's go. Not really much to say from the last mission. And I'm kind of, sort of, conscientious of time. It's like 10 past 4 now. I may or may not be able to get round to doing any Doom and Baldur's Gate stuff tonight. It depends.
I will call the winds. Wait for the winds before letting the enemy come close in the place of prayer.
So the first mission here is you have to defend the prayer, the temple, from being interrupted, which is Zhu Geliang's temple. You know, where he summons the winds to strike. So basically to do that, you take out this gate captain, and then go rough up Zahu. And I think we can actually do a bit of a sneaky little charge here. My bodyguards won't get in the way. So yeah. Then you should do some more risky run missions. Again, if you don't have a horse, this is a bit time consuming. But basically, there's a bit of an opportunity here I can try and take with Zahu Wong. Since he was on his own, he's not anymore, but I'm gonna gamble anyway, screw it. moved position, but I think we can kick him out very quickly. So I'm just going to wait for the cutscene to appear first before I attack.
I cannot be stopped.
I mean, I could deactivate these cutscenes, but people seem to like them, and no one seems to object to them, so won't be doing that. Here comes his Musou strike. Another good thing about that is that basically forcing them to play their Musou into your deadlock is really kind of useful. It means you won't get interrupted by it later on. No, I screwed up the timing. He's a pretty quick character in Saiyan 1. Wait, his guard down there a little bit. Oh, I might have got more of a combo out of that if he stayed against the wall. Oh well.
Here's someone even I can't beat. Fall back.
That dealt with. Excellent. So that takes care of Zahu 1. Now, I'm sort of... Now, to make this mission really stupidly easy for later, but it's a very risky venture if you do it too late or very early. If you want to make Chibi ridiculously easy for yourself, what you should do after that is, since you've kind of prevented Zahu 1's forces from taking over the temple, I mean, they are kind of pushing now, but we're going to gamble if they don't actually succeed. Not that it'll matter too much anyway. I mean, you sort of gamble on morale a bit here, to be honest, but you should be fine. You notice that all the gate captains at the back, you can hopefully you can see it. Hey, murder puns. Good to see you. The main strategy you want to do, and I have mentioned this before, is while the majority of the Wei army don't arrive, is all the gate captains are woefully underdefended. So what you want to do is you want to take all of them out. I mean, you can probably see them at the back there. All of them are unguarded, except this one here, which has an archer tower next to it, which is a fucking pain. If you can take out all of these gate captains now, before Cao Cao's main reinforcements show up, this mission becomes basically stupidly easier. Because, again, you don't have to deal with lots of... God damn it, Jiggy Leo.
Eastern wind. Jubileon. He's a devil.
Lovely lip syncing that doesn't sync up at all.
All units, move to counterattack.
Best voice acting in the game.
One guy, launch the strike.
Actually, this is not even his worst vocal sample.
Oh, good. The wind. We shall begin the counterattack. Don't be late.
Yeah, that just seemed really, really goofy, that, by the way. So while all that's happening, and it was kind of lame that interrupted me during my killing of the gate captain there, but whatever. So that's two down. There's a whole kind of thing where you're probably wondering, okay, why are they both mentioning about counterattacks when they're on the same team? Well, for those who have played my Hungai and Xiaoyun playthroughs kind of know that basically in the terms of the battle, Wu and Xu want to claim this victory as their own. So when Xu does their shit, and if you play as a Wu officer, they kind of go about, do not let this be a victory for Xu. This victory shall belong to Wu! Evoking some of the best voice acting in the game from Shouyu, which is so, so bad that it's even worse than Tidus from Final Fantasy X. It is worse with the ha-ha-ha phrase or whatever. And Shu likewise want to win the battle for themselves. So we're even going to ignore Yue Jin here, because we're almost finished our little objective. So yeah, gate captain's unguarded. If you go there a little later, they're not unguarded. They have archer towers and everything. It becomes much difficult. And the tide will flow for a bit. But, pick up the gate captains. And, battle is yours. I'm going to try and charge up... trying to charge up my, Musou meat before I execute this combo here. Come on, don't drop, don't drop. No, he dropped. That sucks. No plus two shield now. Oh well. No worries. So, what are you doing for New Year's then, Papa Smurf and Murder Puns and anyone else? I asked us in the first part, and I'll ask you again. Right, so all the gate captains have now been eliminated. Now all we need to do is pick off all the other guys. I think Yu Jin will be a prime first target over here. Since he's by himself and is closest to the massive mass that's going to show up in a little bit.
So they join.
I think I'm going to kill him. Ooh, he survived by a sliver of health. Not much longer. Did he just drop a plus two attack?
Another army?
Okay, that's kind of weird. Why did a generic officer drop a plus two attack bonus? That is very strange. That's not normal. Normally they either drop items, weapons, or stat bonuses. I've never seen a generic or playable officer drop an attack plus two bonus before. That is weird, actually. I wonder if it's because I've never seen that. This is very strange. Oh, here's Zhu Huang again. Got a bazillion archers.
Dom, won't you cross swords with me?
Oh, I'm going to a masquerade ball, Papa Smurf. In about 3 hours. I'm literally trying to grab this. Got him. Beautiful. There we go. Screw your bones, pal. God. Things aren't going too well in the middle. Perfect. Oh no, he blocked. Yeah, I'm going to a... instead of friend, one of my friend's friend's house. So, all fun, I suppose. I wonder if I can kill him before he breaks out his music. Nope. Style finish.
I have finally met my match.
A little better than last year. I didn't really do all that much at New Year's, but it was still fun. Cao Zheng's going to retreat. Alright. But yeah, that was... oh god, he's going to interrupt, isn't he? I'm trying to move out as quickly as I can here. Alright, where's the... Is he a retreating officer? Checking, hold on. Yeah, he's just retreating. He'll be leaving, I think. Alright, whatever, we'll leave him alone, I guess. Yeah, he's just a sub-officer. Kind of another weird quirk. If you actually can... when you defeat a main officer and stuff, I'm gonna do a bit of running over here. If you defeat a sub-officer... a main officer and the sub-officers are still visible on the screen, you can actually see them on the map.
Zhou, you are a fool to mock.
So this is the Hongai plan, in effect, where basically they bomb the boats. Hongai's fire.
Cao Cao is beginning to retreat. Cut off their path of retreat. We will take Cao Cao.
Yeah, so that's that plan. But the sub-officer will still be on the screen and is visible. You can also kill him as well, if you wish, but you don't really gain much from it. You get a very paltry drop, because, you know, they're surrendering, retreating, whatever, it's kind of dishonorable, blah, 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 whatever. But they're still visible on the screen. Cool quirk. So, with the fire attack successful, the boats now bond a little bit.
This doesn't look good.
So now I'm going to go up, you know, Gan Ning with his rest of the Wei forces. There's Shou Yu.
Another army.
Just need to quickly navigate where the main officers are. This all can be a bit awkward to get around because of the narrow boats. You know, it's the impression of a naval battle, but actually you just fight on boat corners. I'm sneaky here, very sneaky. Their archers are distracted. If I don't attack them, they won't change their aggro, and I can just, they'll just not fight me anywhere. So here's Suitepee. He plays a much significant part for Wei in future games. And here though, he's just a generic officer. part of the love interest. He sort of becomes Senji's wife in later games. Like, that's kind of a quirk that's used in a couple of later games. You know, it's Senji's husband. Sorry, I'm just kind of spouting off random lore here. As such, I'm just trying to make up conversation, you know. This is a live stream and no one's talking, so gotta stay stuff on the fly. Which is fine. Alright, so almost defeated Navion. Get him out of the way.
I defeated Robert.
Okay, next up, we need to go back the other way. Just to remind you all, the reason I'm doing Liu Bei is because someone on the one of my videos called Liu Bei requested a playthrough of Liu Bei's campaign, and I agreed to it. I agreed to consider it, and then I realized for this special, I'm trying to cover a little bit of each game that I've done on my channel. You know, Dynasty Warriors, Doom, and Bowser. And I thought, oh, what the heck? I'll do Liu Bei's campaign. Why not?
You should not be so eager to die.
So Liu Bei appreciates this, although I apologize because it kind of feels like I'm running through the campaigns. You know, it's partly because I sort of know how these missions go, and it's partly because I'm aware of the time factor. That, you know, I want to try and get this done and maybe at least cover some of the other two games I'm planning on doing. And here's the fire. Doesn't really do anything, just changes the visual look of the level. This would not be the case in later Dynasty Warriors games where fire would actually hurt you.
Even the great Zhang Liao must lose sometime.
Yep, you will certainly lose sometime. So that's that. Bodyguard there with a lovely assist. It's a shame they don't have all the attack I'd like, otherwise I'd probably have killed him in one blow, but whatever. Maybe I have my super switch. So I hope you do enjoy the playthrough, Liu Bei. Hope this was good for you. But I hope that nobody else really kind of requests Dynasty Warriors 3 character playthroughs. Because as much as I do enjoy doing this, but I've really covered all the ground that I can with Dynasty Warriors 3 characters. Yes, I know I've mentioned this in the past. I'm going to mention it again. You know, I've covered all the ground I can. There's nothing new to show. I think this playthrough will actually show the last level that I didn't cover in anything else before. Oh no, wait, no, I tell a lie actually. Xiao Yun had it on his mission. So I've covered every map, basically, at least once. So then there's nothing new to show really, aside from very slight tweaks to the level because of character decisions. Is that Cow Cow? Oh shit, it is. Whoops, I'm jumping the gun a bit here. Oh well, best to deal with these archers early. Wasn't actually intending on fighting Cow Cow, but he seems to be trying to retreat. Whatever, he'll get blocked. This makes me want to start that Shadow Warrior remake I bought yesterday. Oh yes, the remakes. My moderator Drowken actually gifted me Rise of the Triad remake, which I've never played before, but I've played the first impressions of it on Boxing Day, and I really kind of liked it.
I eat guys like you for breakfast.
That is an awesome club, you know.
Reinforcements! Press the attack!
So, Kalka gets a bit cocky now that Wei reinforcements have arrived. They're not really that impressive, though.
Still have this many troops left.
Oh, wow, we're actually sort of
don't waver, we still have the upper hand.
Oh, here we go. Never mind. No, we don't. Oh, I didn't die. Damn it. Gotcha.
That's it. I quit.
And I really like Rise of the Triad remake. It's actually a pretty cool game. I've never played the original, but it was a hell of a fun game. I might tackle that at some point, but I'm not sure what capacity. I might even do it as a Let's Play project next year. alongside a couple of other things I want to play next year. Wow, Capcom sure shifted his position quick. Went from the training to returning back to where he's supposed to be at the beginning of the level. I'm just trying to find the sub-officer. Oh, it's down below. Oops. Expect to see a few more FPS games next year from me. I've also got a copy of Blood.
I shall put an end to this.
Yeah, I heard the original version had a lot of errors, a lot of bugs or whatever, didn't have the best playthrough. I've heard it's like up to patch 1.3, and I've noticed there still seems to be a few moments where the AI sort of doesn't react, but otherwise it seems a solid game. You know, it's got a very old school... This is a bit awkward. Can I grab him? Aha, moved you too much. Bye bye.
I was careless.
Concerned we were.
I defeated.
They basically massively improved the game. From what I hear, the original was quite buggy when it came out on release, anyway. Alright. So all that's left now is to defeat Cow Cow, who is just over. Oh no, wait, there's another. Oh no, that's someone who's just retreating. Never mind. Alright, so he's running away, whatever. Let's just get Cow Cow defeated already. I've got like 6 more missions to do. Yet.
I shall destroy all who get in my way.
Cow Cow's beard get up, so awesome. Musou counter time. Oh god, I missed because it was a vertical strike. Sucks. We noticed how quick Cow Cow was there as well. He also took advantage of a very brief pause in Liu Bei's Musou there to actually block. No, I am taking advantage of the whole charge attack thing. Power up my moves a bit just in case. And again. With a lot of health. Musou again coming out probably. Oh god, yep, he managed to catch me thanks to his stupid bodyguards. Actually, I'm surprised he didn't heal up there, to be honest. Oh, this is a bit scary. This is almost game ending, this.
Do not think this is the end. I'll be back.
Yeah, we'll eventually get you, Cow Cow. Don't worry. That could have been scary there. If he'd actually killed me, if he got a good combo off there, I'd have lost. Because he hits pretty hard. The commanders hit pretty hard at this point. Okay, so that was the battle at GB. Done the very quick way. So, took out all the gate captains, which really made the way reinforcements seem weak, but they're not usually. They're usually a bit more substantial. But again, I'm just plowing through. Took out Zahu 1 early, the back changed. 2-1 fell, Eugene, Cao Cao He. Zhang Liao fell and though towards Jin Shu. Zhang Dun showed up with the Wei reinforcements but was taken out. And then Cao Cao fell again in about 60 minutes. I'd recommend it, Murder Funds. It's a great game. Oh my god, we are still not getting his second weapon. What is this? This is insane. I'm getting no up with these weapon drops, I tell you. It's a good thing Liu Bei's a pretty strong character overall. So again, the bodyguard survived, so we get 6,000 points. Great. Come on, bodyguards, get some points. Yes! They get more attack. Good. Right, I'm going to change the focus a little bit now, I think. So, I think I'm getting some life and Musou points at this point. But yeah, my bodyguards are already going to be a lot more tougher than they were for DL Chun next time. A bit more attack to them. Again, top of the points ranking. Not on the KO ranking. Ooh, fastest time. Nice. Even faster than Zhang Jiao's point. Excellence. Alright, so now, mission 5. We've only seen this mission once before, and that was with Xiao Yun. And now we're coming back to it again. This one does not appear too often. Amazingly, because it's a Shu-only mission, and only a few characters basically get involved in this. Xiao Yun's one of them, Liu Bei's another, and there's a third one. Anyway, introduction time.
Together, the combined forces of Liu Bei and Sun Quan meet Cao Cao's fleet at Chibi. Despite being outnumbered, the strategies of Zhuge Liang and the other advisors proved successful, defeating the much larger Wei fleet. In the year 211, a messenger from the neighboring Yi province comes to visit Liu Bei in Jin. Liu Zhang, fearing invasion from the surrounding countries, asks his relative Liu Bei for reinforcements. The land of Yi province was extremely fertile and prosperous, but a number of people were dissatisfied with the weak Liu Zhang. Additionally, people within Liu Bei's camp began to cry for him to take Yi as well. Reluctantly, Liu Bei begins making preparations for war.
So in this mission, basically, this is where Shu start to build up their own kingdom. And they do this kind of reluctantly against someone who is an ally of Liu Bei, somewhat. So it's kind of interesting how Shu's kingdom really begins. So there's us. There's Xiao Yun, whose livestream playthrough of this is the only other time we've seen this mission. And there's a very mysterious, very under... I'd almost say very underutilized character, Pang Tong. Not really sure why, but he's not a character that many people think of when they think of Dynasty Warriors games. Bit of an enigma. Weird character. Very, very strange guy. Especially when he plays him. Anyway, there's Liu Zhang and all his men. Nothing much to say. An army of generics, basically. So, victory, defeat Liu Zhang, defeat Liu Bei's killed. I actually think there's supposed to be a second way of making this mission end. I think you can end this mission without actually killing Liu Zhang, but I think you can actually end this mission. I think you can actually end this mission without killing Liu Zhang. I don't know if it'll work if you're playing as Liu Bei, though. I think basically if you go to Liu Zhang with Liu Bei, I think there's a peaceful conclusion that can be reached, but I'm not sure if it happens if you play as Liu Bei. I'm gonna stick with the same thing, except we're gonna change the bodyguard's priorities from attack to life and Musou. Give him a bit more health for next time. Otherwise, just keep the equipment the same. No real reason to change anything there. Alright. Oh man. And now we have to go eat a pizza. Like in 5 minutes. I'm just having no luck today, am I?
Are you actually asking me to attack my own family?
You must obtain Shu, or you cannot stand against Wu and Wei.
What? But that is against all propriety.
If you do not, Cao Cao will surely prevail. Neither propriety nor justice are served. Still, to secure the future of the land, you must fight.
What? Nothing but silence?
Okay, so we get the very similar trick here that's used in
Chendo is just across this cotton field. Careful coming out of the forest.
It basically uses the same trick as the stone sentinel maze, where you can't to ascertain your position. To break that, simply just use the map. There's a lot of ambushes that happen here. So this is kind of a cool opening, actually. Just going to make sure that L2 triggers so you can see the L2. Yep. Basically, just using the map kind of breaks this apart a bit. So this is the mission, basically, where Shu is acquired. You know, the actual kingdom. Oh, man, I'm getting no luck today, you know. I'm thinking I might get a lot of time now where I don't get interrupted, and yet I'm going to be interrupted again. I need to prepare some kind of fill material to fill the timing. You can see the music also goes dead quiet for this part. It's kind of a cool effect, actually. The music just places this weird ambience thing. You go into the forest. Just a nice trick, really. So in about 5 minutes, I'm going to have to prepare some... Oh, for fuck's sake. Yes, bodyguard. Making paper, knocking me off my damn horse. I just want to get out of this bit. Trying to figure out where to go. Oh, yes, I know what we need to do. So head back in. So you can see, it switches to an ambient soundtrack for this part. Just going to check the map here just to make sure you navigate. Kind of a cheap way to negate the whole thing, but whatever. It works. You'll probably figure it out on your own pretty comfortably. Oh, I hate the fact he has a vertical strike. I'd much rather have a horizontal one. It means you have to be more precise in the air. Annoying. Alright. Your morale may be increasing now, buddy, but not for long, I wager. Bam! Another vertical strike and I miss.
I defeated an officer.
Get out of here. Right. Deng Xiang's eliminated. There's some fucking archers. I think I can get past them. Hopefully without having to fight the buggers. Do a little U-turn here. Quick U-turn back into the forest. Ugh. Now on this mission, there's one kind of event that you'll want to sort of prevent. And it involves Pang Tong here. So we're going to go ahead a little bit and follow Pang Tong's route because...
So they have joined up.
The really good thing about the missions where you play as the commander is you can be as reckless as you damn well want. Which is always a big advantage, really. You know, you don't have to worry about anything like, say, losing the commander. Because you are the commander, so you only lose if you die. Which if you're playing good, is never going to happen. Do here is we go ahead and we need to kill this guy because if Pang Tong kind of goes forward, he runs into an ambush and you have to save his ass. I think it's also how you unlock Pang Tong as well when playing the game normally, anyway. So Zhang Ren goes down and out the picture. We could actually just end the mission right here, which I'm very tempted to do, kind of. For the sake of time, I might just end this mission quick. Well, at least we'll take out the gate captain anyway. Right, let's go. So Zhang Ren's force is destroyed. We're out of half. Whatever. Pang Tong's event doesn't happen. Oh, man. Oh, God. Yeah, I remember this bit. Another archer's nightmare. Hey, archer. Which isn't say smart enough to retreat at times as well. Hate him, hate him, hate him. And the annoying thing about archers as well is that you can't really not ignore them. It's not like melee attacks you can brush off. No matter how powerful you are, archers always make you flinch, which is the main reason why they can be kind of annoying. You know, if an archer hits you in the back when you're...
So this is Liu Feng Po, huh? What a strange place.
Never mind, I guess he gets ambushed anyway. My memory perhaps a little bit rusty on that one. Oh, actually, no, I think actually I've saved him from the ambush, I think. Because I killed Wu's, that other guy, so I think he's still in trouble, but he's not being ambushed somewhat. But yeah, you know, the thing about archers is it's not so much that the damage they do, although that's definitely an aspect of why archers are so damn annoying. It's the fact that if you're in the middle of a combo on an officer, and you're like low on health, and you're trying to strategically take them out of the picture as quickly as possible, all it takes is one archer to show up. Sort of glitch for the horse there, though, you saw her. It's one archer to sort of flinch you, and then the officer will get a chance to attack, which makes the mission which could suddenly lead to your death. So it's like you're on low health, you're fighting Cow Cow, you get flinched by an archer, Cow Cow puts out a Musou attack, and then that's it. You're done for. And yeah, I think we are going to end this mission quite quickly. Sorry, Liu Bei. But there's not really much else to this mission besides Pang Tong gets ambushed, you're in a forest, you fight a bunch of generics to get out of the fight. And looking at that, that is like archer damage crazy. This is... I actually have to go and deal with them because I could possibly die here if Liu Zeng decides to be all commander me. I'm not trying to move my moves over to kill one archer. That's not forgetting the archers in the towers and the aggressive AI, which is the other thing that can really screw you over. At least archers are usually weak. Thankfully. Try and catch him. Uh-oh. Oh, God. And now I have to be interrupted again. Alright, sorry about that, guys and girls. I am now back, having eaten a delicious pizza. Hopefully my channel is still up. I know that Twitch doesn't like non-video games. So, let's get this battle finished, shall we? So I'm down to about an hour and a half of free time now, thanks to that. This is only the halfway point of Liu Bei's campaign. We've got a lot to do. Get out of the way, guys! I'm going to try and thin these numbers down a bit before I attack Liu Zeng. And yeah, I've actually watched that episode, Draoken. I've watched the whole episode of, that one. Oh god, no, it faded out too late or whatever. More bloody archers. Nice try on the knee attack, pal, but not gonna happen for you. I see we're starting to thin out the numbers at the back here. So, victory should be within our sights quite soon. Got the archers in that tower, annoying. Yeah, I saw you there, Mr. Aggressive. Yeah, I've watched the entire thing. I said, I've watched the entirety of that episode. So, and I enjoyed it. It was kind of interesting to see their perspective of the company in the past and what they're originally going to do for Dynasty Warriors 4. So the game I really looked forward to back in the day. Oh, here's Wee Zhun. Oh, the bodyguard pulled a nice move of it. Did a ton of damage as well, I think. Yeah, these bodyguards are actually starting to do a bit more damage now. They're wrecking stuff up, which is good. Look at that. Decent damage. And they are using their third tier weapon, by the way. The best weapon they can get for the spear.
I am here for your head.
Alright, are we going to resolve this peacefully? Let's find out. I'm going to assume we can't since we're playing as Liu Bei at this particular moment. But I could be wrong, maybe we can still resolve it. Who knows? Alright. Oh, I just dodged his move then, that was good. Okay, Liu Zhang, get off your horse. Time to hand over your keys to the kingdom, pal. Hope this won't take too long. Combo time! I don't want him to stick too far out of his pathfinding, huh? Yep. Bam! Gotcha! It's going to take a while here because I'm by now I should have my second weapon, but I don't. Hopefully one of those guys earlier actually dropped it, which would be good. Oh, he caught me. Damn it. Come on. Run out. Ugh. Try and finish him off in an interesting way here, if I can think of it. Oh, this might not be the most interesting, but it's done.
So you want Chendo this badly?
I don't have much of a choice. I didn't know how to do it peacefully, so you die. Alright. Alright, looks better when he's got the sun glow on him, admittingly. Looks a bit better. Alright then, so, assault on Chengdu. Can be a tricky mission, but I made it look very simple. Took out those generics, took out the gate captain, and just took out the commander in 10 minutes. Simple stuff. At last, the longsword. Second tier weapon. About time. As well. Alright, it's only 3,000 points since we got to a short mission. See what happens. Come on, bodyguards, get another point so I can get your life and Musou up a bit. Fortunately, not to be. But at least Liu Bei is rank 4 now. We've not done this mission with any other character in Extreme Legends, so came 5th there, not appeared on the KO list. Oh, wow. Only 1 second behind the top time. Oh well. Right, mission 5. We're now halfway through, if you can believe that. At least I think we're halfway through. I don't know. This is kind of late-ish, actually. I'm trying to think what other missions you'd be involved in at this point, but... Oh no, actually I can think of the missions that will fill in the gap. Anyway, introduction for another mission that's previously only been done with Xiao Yun's livestream playthrough, Mount Ding Jun.
After the defeat of Liu Zhang and Chengdu, Liu Bei succeeds in taking the Yi province. Thus, Zhuge Liang's heavenly triangle plot is realized, with a table set for the three countries of Shu, Wei, and Wu to battle for control of the land. Having strengthened Shu's defenses, Liu Bei sets his sights on Hangzhong. At that time, Hangzhong was under the control of Wei, whose power had spread far to the west. However, if Liu Bei can take the strong point Mount Dingjun, the capture of Hangzhong is a definite possibility. In 219, the Shu forces head for Mount Dingjun. Attacking a nearby mountain, Huangzong calls out the Wei Dingjun forces. The two armies clash as battle ensues.
Alright, so this mission is mainly notable for the fight between Huangzong, an old timer in the Shu ranks, and Zahu Wan, who are both basically sort of infamous archers. And conversely, they have a bit of a scrap here, which is the most notable thing about this battle aside from the map. So we are the commander here, there's Huangzong, and there's Guan Yu. And for Wei, there's a generic, there's Zahu Wan, and Shang Yi. Simple battle conditions, Liu Bei must not die, that's us. Cao Cao must perish. He hasn't appeared yet, but he will eventually. Now we can finally upgrade our attack. Nice, get arrows and meat one recovery as well, that's pretty good. Not gonna change anything else, so let's get on with the mission. How much time do I have? Alright, it's just ticked 5.
Hanzan is on the other side of this peak.
Lord Liu Bei! Let us begin our march! My bow thirsts for some of these enemy generals, and it must be satisfied!
Once we cross this mountain range, Hanzong will be ours.
be ours to take at will. We shall take Mountain Jiu.
We can use the ridges and drive them over the edge.
And there's Red Hair with Guan Yu. Now, this mission is also notable for its map design, which is basically a lot about mountains and stuff. I'm going to go this way first.
They're strong.
Good thing we have our...
They came as expected, but they can't pass through here.
Stupid horse man, get out of the way. There. Have you noticed how the broadsword actually gives Liu Bei a lot more reach already? The reach has already massively increased, and this is just his second weapon. It gets even more ridiculous when he gets his third. The range is just insane. So let's see his fourth. Oh, I was going to say let's see his fourth combo, but I was interrupted. Let's try it again. Nice. The way he spins in the air as well when he does that. He sort of does a little twirl in the air before executing the downward strike, which looks kind of nice. So we've now defeated.
We must not fall behind.
So I've got about an hour and a half to get through five maps
we
just to finish this.
Fall behind.
So I may have to be a little more rushing, I'm afraid, which is kind of a shame. I'd like to have had more time for this, but I do what I must. So the other thing about this mission, although I'm not really showing it here, is that there's a lot of mountain ridges and spike traps, which you probably will see in a moment. Cao Cao's main force has arrived, so now we can defeat Cao Cao if we wanted to.
There is nothing my claws cannot tear.
Nothing, huh? Maybe we could put that to the test. You can see his Musou attack there, he's sort of gliding around. You'd be able to see it a bit more if the horses weren't in the way, to be honest. Oh, it's a good thing about that is that he's not going to be able to Musou counter this.
Destroy those people who have killed my lord! Let us fight!
As you can see, Huang Zhong is a great shot.
Grace is equally important in retreat.
I defeated Rock.
There's a plus four, meaning that we're starting to get some better bonus drops from these people. I'm going to pick that up just to power up my bodyguard's health, if nothing else. Alright, so Shang He's out the picture. Now we're going to take care of Zahu Wan real quick. I mean, real sneaky. Get to play this map as a wave perspective, so it could be interesting to see how they do it.
I cannot be stopped.
So this is basically skipping a sort of the downward bow you're supposed to normally approach him with, but screw it. Again, there's really not much to this other than just maps and I'm gonna not bother with my Musou this time, so it doesn't trigger it himself.
I defeated Rock.
And that's him out the way.
Brother Doon, I leave the rest to you.
That's actually quite a dramatic death right there. A bit different from the normal sort of death's cutscene events you get. And that's basically the end of Zahu 1, in a nutshell. Ah, now you're going to notice the whole mission thing. You see these spikes? There's a slant on the hill that will basically mean you have to go along the spikes. If you go into the spikes, they do a lot of damage. My forces are mobilizing. Good. I think Zahu Dun does show up in a minute, but I'm just going to try and take care of this gate captain real quick. This is actually a bit risky here. There's a few archer towers as well, as you can probably see. And a lot of nasty AI aggressive guard captains to boot. So I'm probably going to do a bit of cannon fodder clearing just to give myself some breathing space here. Good thing I have that Musou charge.
You're a
Ah, man, I am not looking forward to editing this tomorrow. This is going to be an absolute nightmare to remember every point I need to cut off. Oh well, this is what I get for sweeping in for half the day. Alright, go for the gate captain now if we can. We may have to fight him and Cow Cow.
I shall destroy all who get in my way.
Yeah, we're probably going to have to defeat Cow Cow at the same time. Do we have to? Let's see how it goes. I'll try and take care of the gate captain first. Nice. I should make this a bit easier eventually. I kind of want Calco off his horse because he's going to be a little pain otherwise. Then I'll defeat his sub-officer here. Fortunately, there's too many people on the screen, so he kind of just disappears into obscurity. Nice. Defense plus 2 for 30 seconds. Very useful, I suspect. Now to... Wow. Go, Yue Ying! That's my music there, Shkari, for some reason. Bam! I'll take that recovery. I don't think so, Cow Cow. Bam! Blocked it. Ah, oh, the fucking archers deny me. No! No, no, no! Oh, he didn't heal up. Unfortunately, there's archers everywhere, which is going to make this very tricky, he thinks. Ooh, he broke his Musou out at the last moment. He actually had an opportunity there if he hadn't broke that out so quick. I'm just blindly wailed my attack there. In style! Nope. Stupid. No, 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 no! Get out of it. Come on. Oh, come on. There we go. Got him.
This is not the end. Until next time.
Ah. There we go. That was a lot riskier than I made it look. With two Archer Towers around, I could one bad combo and I was dead. Very risky venture, that one. Are people still here? Was everyone just eating their own pizzas, perhaps? Alright, so we basically took out Zahu 1, Shanky, and then Cow Cow. Ooh, 7 minutes. That's really fast. I don't think I've ever done a mission this quick before. True. Not bothered about the stats for that weapon. Ooh, that's a good upgrade. Ish. And speed. That particularly... Yeah, max, I think. Oh, that's good, Baba. Glad to hear that. Fourth. Ooh, we got a lot of points for queer time, but maybe a bit more. Alright, so 4,000 points. Come on, bodyguards. Please rank up again. Yes! They got a growth point on their life. Oh, excellent. Hello, Virtual 904. You had it muted. I see you're still enjoying the Dynasty Warriors footage. What do you think of the game now that you've seen a bit more of it? Top on points, not on the KOs. A good 3.5 minutes ahead of DL Chan on the queer time ranking. Excellent. Alright, so that's mission 6. Four to go.
Lord, please wait! Now is not the time to attack Wu! We must join with them to attack Cow Cow!
Never! I will destroy Wu! Who cares about Cow Cow? I shall never forgive them! Never!
Liu Bei is very pissed. And he has a right to be. But it's kind of his own fault. Ish. Let's find out why in introduction real quick.
In their attack on Hanzong, Huanzong and the Shu army take Mount Dingjun, emerging victorious over Wei. Using this victory as a stepping stone, Liu Bei gains control over Hanzong, declaring himself its new ruler. Shu has little time to celebrate their victory as Wu attacks, and catching Guan Yu off guard, retakes the Jing province. Determined to seek revenge for Guan Yu and strike Wu, Liu Bei prepares for battle. Leading his forces east, Liu Bei forms a long formation just outside of Yiling. Then in the year 222, Lu Xun, who had been quietly watching the situation, makes his move. Will Liu Bei emerge victorious, realizing his long-held ambition?
Okay, so it seems like here Wu were on the aggressive, but it's actually a bit more complicated than that. Apparently the reason Wu attacked in the first place was that basically, apparently Shu and Wu had an agreement over some piece of territory, and then Shu broke the agreement, and then Wu attacked them, and in the process supposedly killing Guan Yu, but he's alive here for some reason. This is normally Ma Chao's position, but it's Guan Yu for some reason here. And then, yeah, kind of Shu's fault-ish, but war politics complicated things. There's Xiao Yun, Wang Song, the very barbaric and simple-minded but very dangerous Wei Yuan, and a genetic there. And for the Wu enemy, Sun Quan leading the charge, in possibly one of the worst positions to attack a commander ever, because of archers. There's Gan Ning. I hope he's not 8-star powered. Basically, we're hoping he's not Wu Boost strength. I think he is sometimes, but other times he's not. Lu Xun, Shun Shang Jiang, who actually married Liu Bei as part of an agreement between Shu and Wu at one point, but that's not really explained in this game story. It is in later games, though. There's Liu Meng and Sheng Fu. Alright, conditions. Liu Bei is killed, and we must defeat Sun Quan. Nothing really to say there, really. Gonna stick with the same items and weapon. Bodyguard-wise... I think I'll get their growth back to attack again, I think. They seem to have enough defense now, I just need them to get a bit more aggressive. Alright then, so let's do it.
All units, forward! We will wipe out the whole Sun clan of Wu.
Okay. There's one event in this entire mission that can basically dictate how this goes for either side. Kind of. And it's an event that involves a fire attack. So what we're going to do is we're going to sort of stay around this sort of area I'm in now and wait for Liu Xun to make his proclamation. As such. Because there's a little fire attack that Wu tried here. We'll take out our wife.
Don't underestimate me because I'm a woman.
And yes, this is Liu Bei's wife. Just not very well explained in this game. It is explained in the encyclopedia that comes with the game, but isn't really mentioned in-game. I don't know why. They do, however... Later Dynasty Warriors games do, however, sort of make a note to mention this as a big deal, somewhat. And I've also played as Shun Shang Jiang in a previous Let's Play, which is a fun character.
I do not want to die. Oh, not yet.
I'm also sorry if I'm kind of talking in a very fast way, Virtual 904, in this little playthrough. I would like to take my time, but I'm on a time limit because I'm going out in 2.5 hours. I still need to have a shower and... I've been interrupted so many times today that I think the only thing that's going to happen is I'm probably just about going to have time to finish this. Oh my god, look at this health. Well, that's not a good sign. This guy has a lot of health. This will take a while, unfortunately. Bam. Didn't think this gate cat on this has much health. It's kind of scary, actually. That's like almost commander sort of defense health right there. I'm not so sure why this particular gate captain has this much health. It's a little weird. Ah, oh, don't interrupt me now.
Formation. Master Juge Leon must be there. However, there can be no mercy. Send a message to Zuron's unit. We will burn the Shu army as planned.
Okay, this is the key thing that we gotta stop. No, no, no. I need to kill this gate captain very quickly. Get off me. Thank you. We need to go over there now. This is a critical part of the mission. Oh god, this could be bad. I think. Oh god, oh god, oh god. I think we may have fucked up. And this is very... Ooh. I really, really hate this thing. I think I might just get to him in time. It's a real close run thing now. You have to kill this guy dead quickly. The annoying thing about this is if you play on the Wu side, there's a bloody Shu officer in the way. If you play on Shu, there's no one. So yeah, this is the big fire attack. Unfortunately, unless you absolutely know this is going to happen, you will not be able to stop it. This sucks. I want to mention again, play on the Wu side, there's someone in the fucking way. Play on Shu, no one is around but you. Last time, however, I did manage to stop this guy when I played as the previous character. This time, however, the fire attack is successful. Wow, it seems like everyone has this defense. This is going to make this really awkward. If everyone has this much health and defense, then my weapons are way undergeared at this point. So unfortunately, this gives Wu a huge turnaround, but we shouldn't let that affect us too much, hopefully. Got him. Good. God, that was awful. Where's my damn horse? So that's not happened last time. Last time I cornered him out. Now, good thing I'm the commander, eh? Now we have to turn the tide, even though our camp's on fire.
We must not fall behind.
Ah. The Soul Sentinel Mage is pretty cool, by the way. It's a shame I can't really show it on this. Or Virtual 904. You'd love the idea of the maze. Is this guy... Excuse me! Excuse me! Hey! Thank you. I think I'm supposed to have my third tier weapon by now, possibly. Oh no, this guy's actually taking normal damage. So maybe it was just those particular individuals. Ugh. Don't know why those particular guys had a ton of health and defense, but that guy had barely any. It's just weird how the scaling of this game sometimes works. The ticker's actually failing to keep up here a little bit. Rao's going down everywhere. We were pushing, whatever. Doesn't matter. We'll turn the tide soon enough. Gunning's probably going to come breaking out of it. Dead naught speed. Perhaps. Ah, good. This is the guy I'm after. You see the morale there really below half for us. So, probably we might see a death of a friend here too. One you might actually fall here. I won't be surprised, in truth. I mean, he's already taken it. If you see stuff like that happening, it basically means the AI is about to kill an officer. This is not really going to turn the tide much, but it gets him out of the way. I think this is my horse. I don't know. The fire also changes the colors a little bit, which is kind of a cool effect. Yeah. I figured that was going to happen. I think I failed to keep up there. It, that can happen sometimes. If you play this game too fast, the ticker updates very slowly, and a lot of things can happen. And now we're really in the shit because...
My duty.
Now Wei Yan's in trouble, and before we know he's dead, but he won't be. Now the main scrappy part of this fight, the middle.
I will destroy you if it's the last thing I do.
The funny thing is, I talked about Gan Ning having the 5-star defense. I think it's, yeah, Wu Meng has it, sort of. He has a lot of defense. There, things are going to shit. Really, really badly. Despite the fact I helped out over there, Wong Quan still fell. I don't think he has the 5-star attack stat, but he has everything else covered. He just takes forever to kill for some reason. Yeah, you can see now it's only just updating the fact I've defeated Sheng Fu's troop, whereas I'm now on to Wu Meng. What we take here fails to keep up to date on things. Morale is still low. That's not... Oh, God. True Musou time! Fire and fury and all that shit. Get charged up. We may have to use a bit of true Musou spam. Oh god, I have to counter this immediately. That was actually really nicely timed by Liu Meng, because now he's gonna get Dizzle on him. Beautiful. That'll put him into true Musou. Oh great, Liu Yan is down. Wow, this is the worst I've seen this battle go for Shu. Oh, that was lucky. That will help. Get out of here, stupid Liu Meng.
My lord, I must leave you now. Long live Wu.
So Liu Meng, now we're starting to kill off characters a bit at this stage. That was a big win there. Big win. But now we're gonna need some help. Seriously. Because, well, we need some help. I think Han Dan's one of the other. Because we have to face Gan Ning at some point. You do not want to go up against Gan Ning with barely any help, particularly. Especially when things are going like this. Because basically, Gan Ning is one of those, has the worst Musou for damage in the whole game. He will destroy you very quickly if you let him. So I do not want him to Musou me at any point.
Do you think you can evade my swords?
This guy can be a bit annoying too, but mostly because he's quite a quick character. Hopefully this is health. No, it is the useless reinforcements. Good. That doesn't really matter at this point. No one's gonna go in that maze. So this is the first mission of this playthrough where I've actually had a bit of problems. Stupid. Woo.
We must not fall behind.
Need help. Where is help? There we go. 57 health. Alright. Where is Wu Zun? He's over here somewhere. Wu Zun is... Where's Su Tai? He will become playable in Dynasty Warriors 4 as one of the new additions. Kind of a pirate captain type person. And a really cool samurai-esque sword, actually. He was fun to play as.
I defeated Rot.
He's always such a generic. Alright. Wipes out him. Oh, another sub-officer. Gan Ning is close. Gan Ning's fight will be fun. Maybe you'll get to see why I'm talking about Gan Ning's Musou so much of him. Hopefully not in my death, though. Be nice. So what do you guys in the chat think good game will come out next year? What do you reckon you'd like to see from game developers next year? In terms of new games, what would you like to see in particular? Anything you've got in mind? Like a particular type of game you'd want to see come out, or a new addition to a franchise you care about, or whatever? Oh, I don't even know what that... God, Captain fell. I can't get his help. So on after his health, really. Alright, that's not fine. Now we can go out looking for people. He's over there. Ah, finally! Wu's on. Wow, that was quick. See how quickly he managed to break out of it? That was scary. He managed to immediately go into his combo after doing his attack. That's how quick Liu Zun can be. Oh god, charge. I'm not... Oh, I played too defensive. Oh, and then I was the wrong kind of aggressive. Hate this guy. He's got the same defense stat as Liu Meng has right now, which sucks. Bodyguard with a nice interrupt there. This could be interesting. Leave my bodyguards alone, you jerk. Damn, but I had enough removed you then. Okay, finally got my Musou attack on me. I was banking on that interruption. Ugh, somewhat. Oh, my.
They call me Ganin of the Bells. Let's play.
Oh, no, not now. This is a horrible time for him to show up. Absolutely horrible. I need to eliminate Liu Zun quickly. Please don't go through Musou. Yes. Good. He's out of here.
I'm too young to die. Oh.
Project Cars looks pretty good. What's Project Cars, Papa Smurf?
Alright.
So here's Ganning. Now then. Have to be very careful, this guy. If he moves us, we are screwed. But we're going to take a lot of damage. Oh no, he also has the same defense stats. Oh, why does everyone have defense up to gills in this mission? He's going to break his Musou out. Come on. No, he's not. Well, actually got the first combo in this mission. Didn't suck. I'm not really sure. I mean, it'd be nice if the Elder Scrolls Online didn't suck so much, but, wow. He put out his Musou attack. Good. I was baiting it out deliberately. Now, you see that Musou attack? It is instant. You will not be able to sort of block any part of it. If one part of that Musou hits you, the rest usually follows. Very critical, therefore, you don't get hit by it. Good. Excellent block.
Man, I really messed up today.
Any game I'd want to see next year? Well, I'm hoping that Among the Sleep will come out soon. That's what I've been waiting for a while. But that's really not a game that's exactly unannounced. I wouldn't mind seeing, maybe, I wouldn't mind seeing, maybe, like, the creators of Afraid of Monsters announce Afraid of Monsters 2 or something like that. That'll be kind of nice. I wouldn't mind seeing like Afraid of Monsters 2 being announced by Team Sidesquare, the people who brought Afraid of Monsters Director's Cut and the stupidly overrated Cry of Fear horror game. Will you get out the way, Xiaoyun? Thanks. I'm trying to end this mission. This mission has already cost me enough time. It'd be nice to see them actually announce an Afraid of Monsters sequel, or just the next, any next game they wish, whatever it is. I don't really care. Just anything, you know, different from them would be great. I'd love to see them have another crack. Maybe using the Source Engine this time would be nice. Alright, so we're near the end game now, but This place is not an easy one to finish off, unfortunately. At least not on this side. And it's mainly because Wu, you will grow to hate Wu in this game for one particular reason. They love packing their defensive end zones with archers. Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of them. As I've already mentioned, archers are a pain in the arse. So, as you can see, there's millions of crossbow bolts flying. I actually have to literally jump spam now, because they just basically say, "Hey, Commander, you're going to sit with about 6 crossbow packs. Who can whittle your health down to nothing?" That's why I hate Wu in this game. They always hide with a bazillion archers. End zone. Sucks. Hate it. So you have to usually pick them all off as quickly as you can. So what I'm kind of hoping will happen is, if I take out the gate captains, the friendly AI will do some of the work for me and start pushing into his base and take them out for me. So I don't have to deal with them. Look at all those arrows. Do you see them? They're everywhere. It's insane. I hate this part. It's a wall of death. And if I get one bad combo, I'm dead. This is all over. Just sucks. Ugh. So before I even attempt... No, we're not too far ahead. We're in the perfect position. So before I even take Sun Quan on, I'm going to take care of all his archer packs first. Otherwise, you'll just get completely scattered by them each and every time. Luckily, though, my bodyguards provide an ample distraction for some of the archer packs, so this will be a little easier. Thankfully. I think that's about half of them down. My ally should be taking care of the rest. There's another pack right there. All pointed at me, of course. Other than that, I don't know. I can't really think of any sort of titles I'd want to see more of. Maybe like, Maybe another Lovecraft horror game would be nice. You know, one that's based directly on the franchise or something. That might be kind of cool. You know, a game that really focuses on a story of Lovecraft, you know, but in modern times. Not just a game that's based off it, but like a game actually is basically a game adaptation of a story. That would be kind of nice, actually. I'd like to see that. I know there's plenty of older Lovecraft games that exist out there that I should be trying. I might try next year, but I'd love to see a modern game do that. Clear of archer packs now. Now we can take on Sun Quan.
Those who oppose the Sun family will die.
This sword's pretty mean too, but I haven't had any chance to play with Sun Quan in truth. So I don't know how powerful he is or how good of a character he is in Dynasty Warriors 3. I think his weapon is probably kind of similar to... Oh wow, he's getting felt with archers now. Ha 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 ha. Serves you right. That's what you get for packing... Ah, you can see how the archers are affecting him. That would happen to me if I hadn't taken them all out. So he's going to get interrupted so many times now, it's going to be funny. He'll have no chance.
For the glory of our family.
And another victory for Shu. So that's Wu out the way. Pretty much. So, run down on the battle. Took out Shung Shanjiang. Quickly took out the gate captain, but didn't prevent the fire attack. Then, bad shit happened. Guan Yu and Wei Yan and Feng Quan all fell. Luckily though, I'm Super Liu Bei and I took out everybody. Seeing Yi Liang shut up to do bugger all, and after Wu Meng fell, I found Lu Zun and searched him down. and then thankfully didn't really get a chance to use his Super Musou attack. Fell. Then the old strategy of taking out the gates at the end. Boss. Wait around a little bit, and Sun Quan fell in under 19 minutes. Community Assisted Racing Simulator. Is that kind of a bit like Track Mania, but more realistic, I guess? Good stats on these, actually. We've got the defense. A good stat. You may need that. Discard, discard, garbage. And once again, all the bodyguards survived. 5,000 points. Ooh, we get 6 bodyguards now. Yes, 6 of them. Sweet. We're up to 6 female bodyguards. Awesome. That's going to be really noticeable next in this next map. For sure. And we're a class 2. We might actually get to max class in this playthrough for the first time ever with a character. Right. Quick look at the ranking. 7th on points. Not anywhere close on KOs. Ooh, and 3.5 minutes short of Zhang Jiao's AI thing. Alright, so that's map number 7 done. Oh no, we gotta do this one? Oh, this'll be fun.
What is this humidity?
I don't see how people could live here!
The Nanman are strong because of their knowledge of terrain. Lord Jugei has advised us to attack their spirits.
Oh, their spirits! Ha! Still, in this weather, it will be hard to endure.
That's it! I'll be all dried up before noon!
In this cutscene, Shang Fei complains about heat. Oh my god, we get to do this mission as well. Oh, this is a time sink. Yep, this is a time sink.
In an attempt to recapture the Jing province, Liu Bei and his army launch an assault on Yilin, defeating Zhou Yu and the Wu forces, thereby successfully retaking Jing. And so the kingdom of Wu was destroyed, allowing Shu's power to spread from Jing all the way to Jiandong. The Shu strategist, Zhuge Liang, sets his eyes north towards Wei, but has one matter to take care of before he can move. There was a growing power threatening the Shu kingdom to the south. In 225, fearful of the future, Zhuge Liang sets out to conquer the southern lands. The Shu forces make their way south, where the king of Nanman, Meng Huo, and his forces lie in wait.
Oh man, this is my favorite campaign in the whole game. I really love this one. This is the one that was included on the demo disc when I first heard about this game, and I still really think it's a great mission, even now. So, Zhuge Liang is now the commander. Hello to Ulili. However you pronounce your name. Welcome! You join us in time for the Nanman campaign, mission 8 of 10 of Liu Bei's Musou campaign, which I'm at a bit of a time stretch to finish. There's Xiao Yun. We're one of his sub-officers. How bizarre is that? He should be our sub-officer, not the other way around. There's Zhang Fei, the Mr. Justice Ma Chao. For the Nanman, the King of Nanman, Meng Huo. One of the characters I'll be playing as a little later down the line, in a wet way. And his lovely Amazon wife, Zurong, will also be playing Ulio. Well, hello, Ulio. And a bunch of other Nanman people we don't care about. Okay, we must defeat Meng Huo, possibly 7 times, in fact. Because Virtual 904, this is one of the missions that sort of bases its boss fights off the Realm of the Three Kingdoms. No, basically, in the Realm of the Three Kingdoms, they defeat Meng Huo 7 times, and he submits instead of killing him. We tend to do the same. Oh boy. Nothing else we're going to change. Let's go. That's fine, Papa Smurf. Getting people interested in the Not a you. Nope, you. Nil. Anyway, welcome.
This battle is not an act of aggression.
Also got some great music as well.
We will attack their spirit and make them submit.
I will plead for your soul.
I can go get something similar to that. So this is Menguo. I can't wait to play as Menguo personally. He's going to be a fun character to play as. So that's technically the end, but not so.
I've seen your tactics. Next time, I'll defeat you.
Oh, right. You, Liu.
I defeated Rob.
Well, hello, you, Liu. Top tier racing sim without the need for a publisher involved. Alright, okay, that does sound pretty good actually, Papa Smurf. I know you're into racing and all that, so that sounds like an ambitious project. Best of luck with it. Rift Sword. So, well, this is actually going to be my 7th Dynasty Warriors 3 campaign playthrough. And the second one I've done on livestream. Although I'm going to be honest with you, I am really stretched for time now. I may actually have to finish this next year. Just last mission of it. But I'll make up for it. I'll just do a 2014 livestream where I wrap this up and do some other bonus stuff too. Ugh, really.
We must fight well.
Alright, so now we're going to go over here for a strategic reason. And hence the origin of the Nanman armor is born. Basically, they take less damage to archer fire. Hence, the item is one of the best in the game, I must add. Oh yeah, what moving modes have I done so far? Well, the campaigns I've done so far, I have done in Dynasty Warriors 3, is... I've done Zahundun and Zushu of Wei. I've done Hungai and Shunshangjiang for Wu. And I've done Xiaoyun and Guan Yu for Shu. And the only reason I'm doing Liu Bei is that there was a request made by Liu Bei in some of my very early videos that I did. So I thought I'd do it for him, to be requested so nicely. And you know, something Dynasty Warriors 3 awaited. Now we must quickly go back to the other way and defeat Menguo again. And I'm also playing the Extreme Legend, which is what this is engine it's using somewhat. Make some slight changes to gameplay. So I've also done Wu Bu and Zhang Jiao's campaign in Extreme Legends, and I'm currently working my way through DL Chan's campaign.
Of course,
and
they have come as well.
Sorry for interrupting all the voice acting, I'm just trying to explain real quick. So, and I'm also planning to do all 7 characters in Extreme Legends' mode campaign. Can defeat him quickly? That'll be nice. No luck. Oh, never mind, he let his guard down. Haha!
Haven't beaten me yet!
I've beaten you twice. What are you on about?
I defeated an officer.
Alright, so that's that. I know what. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm going to specific locations, it's because this is my third time doing this map, and I know every appearance location of Menguo. So I know this map pretty well, and I strategize very smartly to do this as quickly as I can. I mean, in all honesty, if I really wanted to be absolutely time-conserving, I could just plow straight to the temple, trigger Menguo to appear. Which you can do if you want to skip this whole kill him 7 times thing. You can basically just go straight to the temple area in the southwest, and he just appears there instantly, and then the end game starts. But it is kind of risky around there, because you had a good amount of archers in towers, so it's a bit risky. Plus, I'm trying to sort of show off the content for the sake of anyone new to Dynasty Warriors that Virtual 904 is, and anyone else who joins in, you know. I don't think it'd be very fair to rush a campaign just because of time. Drowken, could you link the YouTube channel, by the way?
We shall catch him again.
Just out of interest, I mean, I've mentioned to Yulai, like, what Musou modes I've done. I guess that you could go over and have a look for yourself. And, you know, also for Virtual Boy 904, so he can... Did I just call you Virtual Boy? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend you. Associating you with the Virtual Boy is not exactly something I'd wish upon anybody. Unless you're a big fan of it, of course. I also love the tribal getup of these non-monsters. It just looks so nicely distinct. It's awesome.
I understand there is another spring besides this river.
He tried to block me, but I still killed him.
I defeated an officer.
Here he is, on a white horse.
Go around this poisoned river.
Hey, Darfrey, how's it going? Good to see you as well. Wrestling stomp. Well, actually, just stomp it. Oh no, he actually broke my dead one. And then followed up with the worst possible thing he can do. I got lucky there. That could have been brutal. Ish.
You again.
I defeated an officer.
You're working, huh? Ah, you're working on New Year's. Well, I guess you know, someone's got to, right? I wish you were able to work and actually watch this. And not just work here, which is always good. I'm finding my horses, actually. This crowd of horses, I've lost mine. Okay. So, trying to jog my memory a little tiny bit here. Okay. I know where he is next now. Oh, that's good, Papa Smurf. Apparently, Dynasty Warriors 8 is a good game. A lot of people have said that Dynasty Warriors 8 is a good game if you want to get into the modern Dynasty Warriors games. But if you want to get into the earlier Dynasty Warriors games, like this one, Dynasty Warriors 3 is a good entry point, in my opinion. Because I just think it's a good game anyway. Poison water! Poison's the enemy too. I don't think it kills the enemy though. Losing them down to zero health. It's like, oh my god damn it! Get out of the fucking way! So yeah, I just get a little aggravated when I'm trying to just get on my horse. Just annoys me. I wish we go around and kill all these clowns. Let's go. Especially since I'm in a kind of a... Alright. So that's that gate captain eliminated. Thank you, Drowken, for linking that. There's the fourth reappearance. Third reappearance, sorry. Fourth total
appearance. The spirit does not appear broken yet.
Not yet. Give it time. We'll break it. Okay, well, thanks for that, Darfrey. That means it'll be awesome, which is good. Maybe we'll get to see it in time, once we get his third weapon. I'm also going to try and upload a lot more frequently in the new year, and have less gaps of downtime, since there's a lot of things I want to do, and I figure I might just... I might even consider starting to do a thing of uploading two videos a day, but I don't know if that'd be overkill or not. It really depends. I mean, I kind of like leaving...
We will not let them pass our army.
Again, we're beating Ming Guo here. I kind of like the idea of uploading just one video at a time because... Oh, wow. That was freaky right there. Both our Muzus...
so fast! I haven't lost a single battle yet!
Great King! Flee!
Oh, sorry.
And that's... it. Where does he appear? Oh yeah, I know. That was kind of a weird...
What? What are these monsters?
Ah, elephants. The mighty power of the elephants. I hate elephants, but they're awesome. Well, I hate... trying to fight against them, I will riding them. I was going to say, that was a weird moment where my Musou and Menkyo's Musou somehow missed each other. Because for a Musou clash to happen, you basically have to hit each other with your Musou as if you... and then the hitbox sort of detects a parry for some reason, and you get the deadlock. Elephants are so awesome. I don't remember if there's actually a... bloody arse. So it's kind of freaky to actually see two Musous get executed and both miss each other, even in invincibility mode, because Musou mode also makes you invincible. I could only be blocked or whatever. Now, we actually do need to borrow an elephant here to break through these barriers. This is one of the very few times where the game has this sort of environmental element to it, which they'd later go on to use a lot more in the fourth game, with towers and siege weapons. But basically, you use the elephants to break these walls that look a little different from the rest of the walls, allowing you access to that part of the level. Nice, fifth weapons. On the hardest level of them all, very hard. I've not even played this game in very hard once. I just remember playing hard way back and just thinking, nah, this is kicking my ass here. I don't remember or not whether or not you get an elephant saddle in this game, unfortunately. I think I remember someone commenting on that way back when I first did this mission, but I don't remember what the answer was at this point. Elephants are awesome! Double attack elephants. The unfortunate thing is that some people will always be just high enough to knock you off it, but otherwise you can just stomp to victory. It's so good. Oh god, here we go again. Double attack for the win!
Why? Why can't I win?
Alright, so it takes care of that. I'm not gonna bother with the elephants. Where am I? Where'd my horse gone? Oh no, don't tell me hex mark disappeared.
What? You've offended my husband too many times. You will pay with your life.
Oh man, is she ever mad? You know what? Sorry, I think we're gonna have to use an elephant because I've lost my horse.
So, the joint.
Good thing there's a shortcut to where we need to be. Bit slow, like. I know that people... You have to kill every officer, including sub, on very hard so they have fourth weapons. No. What, fourth weapons actually drop as normal drops on very hard? Look at that, I just love the stomp. Here we go. AoE stomp attack! I love this mount, it's just ridiculous.
This might be the last push.
Oh, this is the one I always... this is the Menkyo appearance I always hated in the past. I have been denied twice the ability to unlock Menkyo normally, thanks to that appearance. Basically what's happened the first time is someone stole the final hit off me, and the second time I didn't get over there quick enough and he was killed. And because I'm doing so well, your allies are very likely to kill him off. So if you want to unlock him without playing Extreme Legends, you have to defeat him 7 times. And that is the appearance that will really, really make it a nightmare. You have to get out of there so quick after you defeat him on the 5th. So, now that I have Extreme Legend as a playthrough, I don't care if I'm walking him, so my allies can defeat him gladly. In fact, they probably will defeat him in a few moments.
We must be triumphant.
Almost. I might just leave them to do it themselves. Can't be arse going over there. Oh, for Pete's sake. Stupid guards. Need to kill them off because their allies are the one that tried to knock you off. Very, very annoying. They have enemies like Ming World. Right, finally. Let's go. Yeah, I've actually been asked by people whether I'm going to do 4th and 5th weapons. I think you were one of the people to ask, in fact. I have considered doing 4th and 5th weapon runs as a sort of side series, but I'll have to see. Oh, for Pete, start this. Elephant's too slow. I'm actually fast on foot. Zion's taking care of the gate. Good. They'll probably defeat the main core in a minute. So we'll just very quickly deal with these gate captains and proceed into the temple. Oh, my bodyguards have knocked him out of the way. They ruined my combo a bit there. Ow. Oh yeah, elephants do a fair bit of damage. Kind of icky. There's Hiniko, one of the newest bodyguard additions. We now have 6 of them. Right. Get out of it, stupid guards. Nasty little guards around here, that's for sure. I basically have a lot to ponder for the new year. What kind of things am I going to do? Dynasty Warriors-wise, I'm thinking of doing Dynasty Warriors 7 next, if I can get it running on my dual monitor setup. Because I know a lot of people have been looking forward to that for ages. But I'm also thinking of doing Dynasty Warriors 4, I'm thinking of doing 4th weapon runs, possibly. I'm thinking of Samurai Warriors, the change of pace. Can I eliminate? I think I'll just... Oh, did someone kill Menkyo off camera? Whatever. This is the final bit of the mission now, coming up. Anyway, knocking off the elephant. Alright. Let's see if we can fight Zurong on an elephant again, like I did last time. Be back on. Where is she located? Oh, right, she's actually not attacking. Not that fun. Time to stomp on enemies! You can also stun. Elephants are ridiculously powerful in this game. They do a lot of damage with their stomp attack. Their only downside is archers and other people jumping on you.
Some moves you got there.
That was a weird cut with a weapon there, by the way, I might add.
We must wait for help to come.
So here she is, Zurong, the wife of Meng Huo. She's the only person in the game outside of custom characters to have female infantry as such. And that's her Musou attack. A bit weird, really. It's a bit of a technical skill, sort of a technical Musou of sorts. A bit like Zhang Jiao's, really, I guess. But we'll talk more about Zurong when I play as her in one of my Let's Plays next year. don't really have much experience playing with a Zugong compared to the other Extreme Legends characters, so not really probably gonna be finding out a lot about on the fly, but I know Amuse's kind of an interesting one. Of course, what would an annoying force be without artifacts, huh? What's gonna be quite a few of them. Alright. And now for a kind of a risky run into the middle of the temple. Oh, right, okay. In Excel only. Okay, fair enough. So, not. But she was the only one until Extreme Legend, anyway, came out. They're very distinct looking ones as well. They're sort of Amazonesses. Alright, so now we're going to plow into the temple. Not the easiest place to fight main Guo somewhat. Due to these guys. Can be awkward. I think where I'm fighting now isn't the worst area, mind you. Just need to knock off these damn archers off the roof. I think then we're good. Okay. Bow captain down. Come on, let's finish him off quickly. Oh no, they. Oh, I completely missed him. Damn it. That sucked. Yes. Oh no, he somehow glitched on the other side. I'm not sure how that happened. He sort of slided on the other side there. That was very weird. Timed it well on Meng Guo though. No getting out of my Musou this time, buddy. Fortunately, lucky you've got guards that will back you up. I love that body slam, it's ridiculous. That's Meng Guo's third attack, by the way. The body slam of doom. That's why I'm looking forward to playing this Meng Guo character. He's a bit like a Zhu Shu, but I think a bit more ridiculous.
I'm not finished yet.
I think because we only defeated him 6 times, we kill him instead of letting him live, but whatever. So that was the Nunmon campaign. Ooh, time for another one, actually. Alright, so I went over. Sorry, I'm going to fast forward just a bit, maybe. So basically, I went onto the left-hand side, took out a bunch of guys as I was defeating Meng Guo. Went onto the right-hand side, took out a bunch gate captain. Went to the middle, used an elephant to break down the walls. Those two were fell. Took out Meng Yu. Pretty much ignored the right-hand side of the map. Dealt with his wife. And all in under 20 minutes. Not a bad time. I think that's going to be the quickest yet. At last, the Gold Dragon. His third tier weapon is mine. Ooh, another Crescent Blade. HP max, I'm gonna put this. Oh, that's good. Musou increases and attack. Nice. That's a good drop for spears there. Alright, and look at all those points. Nearly 8,000. Very nice. That should give a growth point to the bodyguard, surely. What? Yes! More attack. Very good. Might get another point here, who knows? That's it for now. Now their attack and defense are almost equal. They're making very formidable. Still class 2. Is he going to make it to class 1? Not this time. Yep, we've topped the total points. Not the KOs though. Oh no. A little shy of Meng Guo's total. That's fine, that's not a problem. Right. Can I pull off two missions before time? I will be cutting it close. We will see. Alright, so the battle at Jating, from the Shu perspective, also kind of an interesting mission. In fact, I don't think I saw this mission from the Shu side when I played as Shaoyun, but I could be wrong. Anyway, introduction.
Zhu Geileon, determined to quash the threat from the south, confronts the Nanman troops and their leader Meng Huo. Thanks to his brilliant strategies, Shu emerges victorious and the Nanman troops submit, awed at Zhu Geileon's power. Dispelling his worries for the future, Zhu Geileon leads the Shu forces north. Attacking the western lands, Shu defeats the Wei commander, Cao Zhen. In response, Wei sends out Sima Yi to oppose the Shu army. In the year 228, Zhu Geileon selects the young and talented Musou to protect Shu's stronghold in Hanzhong, Jating. Focusing on protecting the main roads, Musou vows to keep Jating out of enemy hands.
Which leads to another interesting plot where Musou is apparently somewhat incompetent and screws up a bit. Elder Sword with plus 20 attack and plus 20 reach. That's pretty good, Darfrey, actually. So once again, we are the commander. Zhu Geileon is our sub-officer. There's Ma Chao, Wei Yan, and Ma Su, Zhu Geileon's pupil. And for Wei, the brilliant Wei strategist Sima Yi finally makes an appearance. I think he takes over pretty much after Cao Cao dies, if I remember correctly. There's Shang He, and there's Shen Ji, the lovely Wei flute player, with a nice AoE attack. And Cao Zhen. Conditions? Oh my goodness. You have to defeat the enemy commander and not die yourself. No way. Weapon-wise, finally time to equip the Gold Dragon. Now this weapon will have a really ridiculous reach. We actually have more attack than defense at this point. In that case, I think next one should be more Life Musou, I think. Or maybe we could put them on balance. Nah, Life Musou. Need more health. Because they're getting pretty tough, these bodyguards. It's going to be very useful when I get back to DL Chan's playthrough. If only Liu Bei was here himself. It'd be nice if Liu Bei was actually here to see this, but now can you do?
Zhang Wei, isn't this land perfect?
It is dangerous. We will lose our path of retreat if we camp on the mountain.
Well now, will Musou be capable of success? Jating is the main city of the Shu army.
Okay.
We will build a defense here and wait for General Zhou Yu.
Okay.
Take a position along the road. Make sure you are not visible from the mountaintop.
Okay.
Your lordship, leave it to me.
We have not done this mission before. On the Shu side. I know just for that opening cutscene we did not cover it. So this is a completely new mission. This is a completely new kettle of fish for me. I am not familiar with what happens here. Except that I do know what happens on the Wei side. First of all, though,
you shall not stand in my lord's way.
A very scantily clad Senji, ladies and gentlemen. Have you noticed the range on the Shaoyun's Liu Bei's weapon, by the way? It is ridiculously huge now. Hope you like Senji's noises. She's very quick, unfortunately. She actually will pretty much not break out of it. Let's see his fifth attack, shall we? Of Liu Bei. It's, yeah, you're right. It is very similar to Guan Yu's attack.
I defeated an officer.
You weren't kidding.
We shall meet again.
What a scantily clad gear, seriously. Alright, well, have a good one, Papa Smurf. Thanks for joining. coming in, and I'll see you in 2014. The browser closed itself. Your browser has become sentient. Ah. That just makes Liu Bei even more ridiculous of a character then. If he has Guan Yu's fifth combo attack, that just makes it even more powerful. It's even quicker than Guan Yu's, actually, I think. Oh, archers. Finish him off quick.
I defeated Robert.
Ah, get off your horse. Count him. Oh, man. No, that archer interrupted me. I was in the middle of doing something good. In the arse there. Well, Tao Zen's out of here.
I defeated an officer.
More plus four to attack. Good, good, good. That's half of the... Uh-oh. Here we go. I think we have to go over there and interrupt now. Because Zhang He's going to have something to say about that. Where is my horse? Where did I put X? He is... Right. So we play our cards, right? Let's go follow Masu. It's a pretty good Musou. I think Sun Jian actually has a better Musou that's very similar to that because it's a lot easier to stay connected with Sun Jian's. Has the same sort of advantages and disadvantages of Liu Bei's Musou, but it's a little easier to keep an opponent where you want them. I'd still say Gan Ning's is the best, though. Just because of how ridiculous the damage is. No officers come. Cool. This is the ambush party. That tries to take out Masu.
You fool! To walk to one's own grave. That Shu General. So stupid!
And he is not impressed. Masu's been isolated. A major focus of this mission is Masu getting caught out like that. Apparently it's quite a rookie mistake, apparently. Oh, so the law of the game would have me believe anyway.
I defeated Robert.
Alright, item done. Officer defeated! Good thing I knew about this ambush was coming because I've played this mission several times on the wayside. It always helps if he's... Now they can retreat. And that's it. That's it through the entire event. Kill one sub-officer from the back. You're done. Thanks for coming. I have played a Sun Jian. I've beaten Sun Jian's campaign when I was bored one night. Sun Jian's Musou just holds an opponent in place a lot better than Liu Bei's does. And that's why I kind of like it. But I'd have to do a direct comparison or something. But I don't think Sun Jian's Musou's bad at all, Garfield. I'd have to disagree with you there.
There is nothing my claws cannot tear.
Except me. Can I come? Aww, oh, why'd you knock them both off at once? It's fine though. Shu forces have arrived. The only thing I don't like about Liu Bei's Musou is that he has his delay in between two of the strikes that opponents can seemingly take advantage of. If I recall correctly, Sun Jian doesn't have that problem. But whatever. It doesn't really matter. All Musous are equally as ridiculous. Ugh. I always hate it when a stupid AI does that kind of thing. Or gets that nasty little combo off you. It also usually means that the enemy officer will heal up then. I'll try. Oh, wrong move. Caught him in midair. Beautiful.
That was an impressive battle. Until next time.
Still, Shang-Yi's out of the picture. Right, gate mission now. God, look at the archers that are way out here. Look, they're all distracted. Now time to break through. Wow, it's actually... Oof. Let's see if I can do this in one go. Ah, good. Xiao Yun has shown up. Get out of here. Right. Get Captain One down. Ugh. Yeah, the archers. I want to try and ignore them, just for the sake of time, if nothing else. Okay. Okay, you can do this if I really want to, I could actually get this all done within the next 20 minutes, if I'm quick enough. But he broke his guard. Excellent. Not so excellent. The archers are about to fall up.
You're even better than they say.
Oh boy. Starting to become a bit routine this now.
My dynasty will be built on your death.
Ah, the arrogant and snidey seeming. An interesting character of Wei in a way. Only recently in Dynasty Warriors 7 did his Jin Empire get a mention. Oh my god, straight Musou off the horse. And that's kind of one of the things I'm looking forward to in Dynasty Warriors 7 if I get round to it. The whole story of the Jin Empire. I know bugger all about Jin, other than Simi Yi was one of the first people to, Oh. This could be bad. Oh no, there's still way too many archers around for my liking, and we're fighting the commander. That could have been scary. Oh god, look at that. Oh Jesus. Moly, these guys have gotta go. Now. Look at all the health that was chipped off just by a heldering of these guys. Right. Well, that's one of the main reasons I'm looking forward to 7, is this Jin Empire. Simi's kind of the first person that started the whole Jin Empire business. I'm really interested to see what their story is. I mean, the Jin Empire ends up being the empire that wins the whole Three Kingdoms thing. They kind of just, they win, basically, after all the Three Kingdoms collapse in the end and take over and unify China, blah, 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 blah. Oh no. Good thing Simi Yi has a very weird move set with his fans. Will you get out of the way? I die. With his fans, he's got a very. Luckily, I've got this move there. Him and Zuge Liang's attacks can be kind of weird at times. Madai, you are causing so many problems for me. You're stupid. Oh no, one of the bodyguards actually got killed. That's not good. First time that's happened in this place. So get out of the way. You're interrupting me. Another thing you're going to grow a hate if you play Dynasty Warriors 3 is your own allies being jerks to you. This. Alright, just finish it. Thank you.
Retreating is part of my plan.
No, it isn't. I don't think so. Another victory for Shu. Alright. So, Jiting's a pretty quick mission in itself. This one seems to be slightly easier than, Now, I'd actually say it's about as easy as playing on the wayside for this mission, really. Except that Xiao Yun doesn't show up and oppose you, so I guess it's that. So, a pretty quick mission, killed everyone under 10 minutes. Masu got surrounded and quickly saved. Amazing maximum forward attack. This is charge. I'll stick the charge, I think. Okay. 4,000 points, and a slightly reduced bonus due to losing a bodyguard. No problem. Perimeter general. Ooh, one away from max class. Ranking-wise, we should have been top of the points ranking so far in all our missions here. Ooh, and quickest time. Sweet. Awesome. Alright. Now. Wuzhang points.
We have finally come this far.
Yes, though it was for the benefit of the land, I have involved far, far too many innocent people. But it was solely for this very moment. Oh, my beloved people, lend me your strength!
Zuge Liang goes full magic mode.
After setting out on its northern campaign, Shu drives back the Wei army at Beijing, getting a foothold in the lands of Hanzong. For Shu, to destroy Ya Castle of the giant northern country of Wei was a victory with meaning. With the Wu Kingdom destroyed, Shu turns its attention back to the restoration of the Han Dynasty and sets out to conquer Wei. Meanwhile, Wei's Sima Yi is given a large army and sent west in an effort to meet this challenge. In the year 234, Zhuge Liang, leading his forces into Hanzong, positions them on the Wuzhang Plains and prepares for the final battle. Wei and Shu, Zhuge Liang and Sima Yi, these two forces are about to meet in the struggle for supremacy.
Alright, so this is the final mission of Liu Bei's campaign. Oh my god, that's not in the worst place possible for what I'm gonna about to try. Maybe not too bad. Alright, so there's us. Zhuge Liang is normally the commander here, but we've taken over duties, which is a good move actually, considering what I'm about to try. There's Zhang Wei. He sort of takes over after Shu crumble, I believe, and cost them a lot of victories, according to the war or something like that. And there's Wei Yan, Xiao Yun, Guan Yu, who's supposed to be dead at this point, and a bunch of others. And for Wei, the final commander opponent is Sima Yi. Zhu Wang, Zhu Xu, Cao Ren, Ji Wang. Okay, battle conditions. Sima Yi dies, Liu Bei lives. Nothing new there. Now, item-wise... What do I give up here? What do I give up? Okay. What is this? I'm going to try a very quick strategy here. To try and get this done in the next 10 minutes. I'm basically going to gamble and I pick up a horse or something in the next 5 minutes. I want to do this because I'm kind of interested to see if I can pull it off. But basically we're not going to fight here for 30 plus minutes. I'm going to try and end this battle quickly.
Now we shall decide Wei's fate. All units, feint towards the enemy and head for their base camp.
If you do this mission normally, this can actually take quite a while, especially when it's your first character. Anyone who's watched my Zanhun Dun playthrough will attest to how long this took first time. It nearly took me an hour. So I'm kind of curious to see if I can end this battle in about 5 minutes. I mean, this is partially due to time constraints on me. I mean, if I don't succeed this attempt and I get killed, then I'll just take care of this next time. But I'm going to try it. I'm basically just going to charge straight at Sima Yi and try and kill him. See if it's doable or not. So, unfortunately, in a very awkward spot. There's not really a fast way of getting to the battle from here. So this is going to be something a bit different I'm trying out. I'm going to see how quickly I can commander rush Sima Yi. And I sort of sacrificed my speed on my horse for true Musou. I'll need everything else pretty much, the HP, the attack defense, and the Musou charge. So wish me luck. See if I can pull this off in about 5 minutes. Should be interesting. Should definitely be interesting to see if I can do a quick run. There shouldn't really be that much in the way, mind you. But getting there and fighting Sima Yi is a different kettle of fish. He does have a lot of archers, I can fully imagine. But I always wanted to give a damn about morale because, you know. Hoping a horse guy shows up. Kind of also hoping these archers don't come too much of a pain.
This? This is his contraption?
Ah, wood ox. Ow. Ah, that horse. Small problem, archers. Sod it. We'll just have to go past. Now, wood ox is Zuge Liang's sort of secret supply weapon. It's basically, in this game, it just kind of appears statically, but apparently in the lore or something at this battle, the wood ox is kind of a mobile supply system that Zuge Liang used. I think the purpose of it was a long battle, they had to cover a lot of distance, and so wood ox was basically kind of like a Meals on Wheels kind of supply system, where he rolled along in these little wooden carts, and basically used to, get past to keep the shoes forces supplied. I don't know if that's the truth or not, but it's something along those lines. It's wooden devices they used to supply the troops. Maybe someone with a better knowledge of the war could fill me in more accurately, but whatever. Alright. So we've made it to the actual point here. Now this is going to be really hard. You can already see the points on the map swing. There's at least several archer towers before we even get to it.
You should not be so eager to die.
You're not supposed to do this normally. You're supposed to kind of take your time, take out the catapults, and then go in. We've even triggered the end battle music. So I'm not quite sure what my plan is going to be here, actually. But what I might do is take out these gate captains as quickly as possible to sort of stem the tide a bit. This might not be a smart part of my strategy either, but I'm going to give it a damn good shot. Again, this is a really suicidal strategy, even though I'm well geared at this point. So one gate captain down. I'm not going to fight Zhang Liao. That should help a little. It's kind of a risky moment in this. I have tried this before, but I usually do it on missions where I know I'm going to powerhouse the enemy, like the early stuff. Never on a late mission. Never with a starter character. So this is really new territory for me. The chat is completely quiet. The chat is awed in silence at how tense this could be. Possibly. The archers will make this more difficult. Right. Ooh, that was a life plus 10. Right. Taking out those guys. Now, archer towers. Do I take them out? Definitely try. Of course, they all fell off. Get off me, you dickbag. There we go. Ah, you missed. Okay, archer tower down. How much time do I have left? I've only got about another 10 minutes to spare for this. Right. I now need to pull Sima Yi over here, away from the other archer tower nests. And then I just need to wear him down, basically. I've chosen to do the true Musou attack here because... Well, basically, I want the fire damage. Okay, where is Sima Yi? He needs to be baited out. Oh god, there's archers here, there's two packs, and he's not coming out. What a dick.
My
dynasty will be built on your death.
Oh boy. Now for the fun part, clearing these bloody archer packs. Oh, this is not fun. This is not fun. Oh, and he has to go for his 6-hit combo. Damn, that sucks. He has to go for his max damage combo. Alright, I need to clear these guys out, no matter what. Yes! Get down! Goddamn annoying bloody archer. Okay. We connect. Yes, we can. Now I need to drag him away from the archer, guys, if I can help it. No! Damn it. Okay, now we should get the regen. Burn him. Yes! God, these archers are still around. My bodyguards are making good disposable. No shit! That could have been a game over there. If that had fully connected, that's a ton of damage right there. Not even joking. That is scary. You do not want to get into Sima Yi's Musou attack. It can turf for you very quickly.
Let us join our allies.
No, I'm not gonna join my allies. Risky run this is indeed. But I'm not giving up now, I'm close! I think his archers are dead as well. I think. God, can I do this? Can I do this? I need to be very, very, very careful now. I don't know where he is. Where's he gone? There. Oh my god, I think I've done it. Oh no, he blocked. Damn it.
Good luck.
Okay. Defense, 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 defense. Got him.
I have done all that I could.
Woohoo! Did it! Get in there, my son. And that is how you do the Battle of the Wuzhang Plains quickly. I actually thought I was gonna fail there. That was fun. Straight over there. Ooh, 7 minutes. That was insane. That really was. But I did it. Aw, no growth point to end. Okay. And with 5 minutes to spare for the ending. Ooh, God, that was good. Not on the point ranking, but by God, we've definitely topped the clear time ranking. Just over 7 minutes. That was fast. Boy, would have been faster if I had a horse, but whatever. It's done. Liu Bei's campaign in its entirety. Finished. That was a well-earned victory. Hey look, it's Liu Bei's wife.
像疲劳，装作无所谓。
小燕是 Suitepee。That's what I'm going to be like later. Very drunk, probably. Oh, match our tents to the horses. Not seen that before. Ooh, they're playing... I've not seen that before either. They're playing that dice game. I can't remember what it's called. Not Mahjong, something else. Like a popular dice game or something. There's Pang Tong. Well, I think Moonwalk are doing this, but we've already got all the cards anyway. Alright. So, that was Liu Bei's Dynasty Warriors 3 campaign in its entirety. Done Dynasty Warriors 3 Extreme Legends style. That was fun. I really did enjoy playing that. I mean, I would have thought by now, seeing that's my seventh time I've gone through the Dynasty Warriors 3 maps and campaign stuff, I thought I'd get a bit bored at this point, but that was actually really fun. Especially the final mission, where I proved you can just suicide a commander if you want to, if you get lucky. I would not recommend trying that without some good items though, Virtual 904. If you do that at the very beginning with no power-ups, it will be a lot trickier. Trust me. And I nearly died as it was. It's just a good thing I got very lucky, and there were bodyguards to also distract some of the archers at key points. This song is called Circuits. So, since I'm about to head out for New Year, what did you all think of that then? What did you think of Liu Bei's campaign? This was entirely done for the user on YouTube called Liu Bei, and I will be uploading this to YouTube hopefully tomorrow. And oh boy, do I have a ton of editing to do before it gets up there.